You got a home invasion story?
You want to go there?
Yeah, I love those.
I got Scorched TV ready to roll.
Oh, fuck. All right.
Let's hear those.
We can do home invasion any day, but we got Scorched TV.
That's a home invasion, too, if you have his channel on. You feel invaded.
We got a... what's the setup, man? Because we do have a lot of...
Oh,
hopefully,
my God.
Hopefully, we have a lot of new people checking us out this week. I guess there's some kind of free preview going on.
Yeah.
I don't know about this. When did that start?
It started technically Sunday. It lasts for this week and next week.
Yeah.
Wow, really?
And all the series.
So we should be doing, like, some special things. Well, we got to hook these people in.
We got the weekend special. We're going out.
I think our brilliant talent just carries it just carries.
But this weekend is the worst of the satellite years.
Oh.
Instead of the worst of the week countdown.
Uh-huh. Great.
It's going to be good.
Anyway, Scorch is we worked with Scorch.
Who is
back in the oldie
this
days.
This girl with a suitcase is trying to get our attention. Who is she?
She's a friend of mine, Tamara. She was waving to me.
Oh,
what does she do?
She's a lawyer. She's a tall drink
of water.
Yeah, she's
but what is she doing here with her luggage?
She's doing radio. She does Red Eye and she does radio. She's a lawyer in Chicago and she does a lot of radio.
Did we have her in here?
No, but she's a friend of mine. So she was just texting me and saying goodbye.
That's nice. Fine. I saw her waving at everybody as she came through with her luggage and now she's leaving with her luggage. All right.
Yeah, Scorch, we worked with him at WAAF when first hooked up in the radio biz. And Scorch worked there also. Well, we went on our merry way, and
he never did.
And had a pretty prosperous, pretty nice career going for ourselves. Knockwood continues.
And he's been stuck in neutral ever since.
Yeah, and Scorch went nowhere.
Absolutely. Well, he went somewhere. Shitty market to the next.
To the next. And apparently now, what he's doing is producing and starring in his own TV show.
God damn, we don't have our own TV show.
No, we don't.
When you think about it this way, you guys went from Boston to New York, and you're still stuck here in New York.
Excuse me, we went from Boston to New York, and then from New York to nationwide.
Yeah.
Oh, Sam.
Yeah. Well, I was going to credit Scorch for going from Boston to Syracuse to Manch Vegas.
Manch Vegas.
Is he still calling it Manch Vegas?
Yeah, that's what the locals call it.
Oh, I'm sure they do.
And what's their slogan in Manchester, New Hampshire?
I don't remember.
It should be, we suck.
Well, they're playing off the whole of what happens in
Manch Vegas.
Manch Vegas stays in Manch Vegas. Well,
what happens in Manchester nobody hears about.
Yeah, no one cares. So Scorch
the
has
home of herpes sores.
Scorch has a TV show.
Yeah.
But it's what he does is...
Whoa. He started on Public Access.
Yes, he started on Public Access.
Which is kind of important.
What's the name of the program?
It's called PFGTV.
What does PFG
stands for?
Pretty effing good.
And the effing is a bad word.
It's a very bad word. You can't say it on TV.
That means pretty good.
Thank God for the beep.
And the lip sync.
Yes.
But he started...
Pretty fucking good.
Oh.
See?
He started on Public Access, doing it out of a bar.
Mm-hmm.
He's moved on since we last visited him.
Wow.
He's trying to do a late night talk show.
So this is taken off, I guess.
It's taken off in a major way. What he does now is he solicits people to be quote unquote sponsors.
Yeah.
And then he uses that money to buy time on the My Network in New Hampshire.
So what he's doing is
an infomercial.
Yes. The show starts with, "The following program has been paid for by private sponsors. They do not reflect
the views of Scorch." Yeah.
So what it is an ad for dick cream or anything that you'd see late at night.
F the director. Sorry, Ryan. Just joking. I think it's pointing at Brian. That's Brian.
That's Scorch.
We're just looking at Scorch.
Wait, you know, he's wearing a white suit. He's dressed like Pablo Escobar before he got shot. And he's at a podium. What's he doing?
That's the show.
That's his desk.
Oh, so he's sitting. I'm sorry, it's a desk.
Yeah. Sitting at the laptop.
Now, what he does is he gets sponsors. One sponsor was this clothing company, and he ended the plug with, "Their clothes are finally going to be going on sale. They should be this week."
Uh huh.
So it's sponsors like that he obviously just goes up to them and he's able to talk to them as if he's a real show, and they take him seriously because they're as much of a joke as he is. And then they give him money, and he puts it in his pocket, and he doesn't pay anyone.
Of course. Why would he?
No.
Now, I see him at a desk that looks like it just is a desk from someone's garage sale or a garage.
Well, he's since moved on from the desk. I guess he thought it did look, and now he uses a side table.
Oh, a side table, and then he's got a couch where his guests sit.
That has to have a lot of jizz on it.
And Nick, his guy on the couch.
Yeah, yeah, it's like a sidekick.
Yeah.
It's set up like a, you know, like a talk show on real television, except it looks nothing like it.
No, yeah, it's obviously.
It's a very cheesy version.
He's got a Toshiba laptop, and instead of doing the smart thing, where he sticks the PFG TV sticker over the logo on the laptop, so it's as if it's a custom laptop, he sticks it above the logo, so you see both logos.
Of course he does.
Am I I bet you he got Toshiba to give him money or something. He probably said...
That's true.
Am I having a seizure?
No.
Are you seeing him, like, jump around the screen? What kind of fucking editing is he doing?
Oh, it's not... I mean...
It's not good.
I thought he was having a seizure. All of a sudden, he was, like, standing up, and then he popped, and now he's sitting back down.
What's happening? Can we start the show? We got to hear something.
Andy,
I can't not hear this.
Andy.
I know. I want to hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's this, the Scorch Man, you know, I'm calling after Howard. He does the whole thing, like the Snapple ads and everything like that. It's corny. It sucks. And he does this other thing, the pause for the cause.
Yeah.
He sticks himself in the cage. I think he tries to assault them
all. Oh, we did the pause in the cause thing.
Right.
Yeah, that's why we were trying to get one of our fans to throw mustard or something.
Well, no, it worked. That's why he doesn't call on the show anymore, because one of our fans threw yellow paint
yellow
over
paint.
Him.
Oh, they did?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Was he mad?
He was very upset.
Very bad.
I don't think I'm any good,
All right, Sam's got better audio than
okay. I now have a source in Manch Vegas who is sending me his show on a weekly basis.
Manch Vegas.
Does he hate us?
He doesn't, no, he still has a lot of love for the Opie and Anthony show, but he probably won't come on the air because he knows that you guys will harm him.
Dude, holy shit, his YouTube clip has 33 views so far.
Are you kidding me?
Fuck, that's good.
It's because there's so many television viewers that they're like, I've seen this on TV.
That's true. Why look at it on YouTube?
I was a huge fan of Scorch.
Yes,
Colin.
I
did. Colin Quinton. Scorch and his TV show. Everything that has to do with Scorch,
Colin loves.
So, all right, Sam cut up one of the shows. Scorch starts the show. It's the first day of spring, and Nick on the couch will be hitting... Nick on the coach? Or
couch.
You meant to say couch.
Yeah,
okay. Nick on the couch will be hitting the streets soon.
Ah.
It's Scorch and PFG TV.
Pretty
cool. Yeah!
Can you pause for 1 second?
Yeah, exactly.
This already stinks.
Who's applauding?
Well, he has an in-studio audience, the crowd, he calls it, of approximately 10 to 11 people.
Uh-huh. Where is the studio, by the way?
I believe the studio looks still to be a public access studio.
Uh-huh.
And then he records it at the public access studio, says that it's live,
and gives it to My9.
And then gives it to My9 and pays for the slot. That would be the truth.
Okay.
And the audience obviously can't, because he has like a local band on. The audience is obviously friends of the band.
Oh,
with
I see.
No interest in what he's doing.
In what he's doing. Well, of course.
Okay.
Yeah! Before we do anything else, first of all, you can continue clapping. I like that, you know. Jesus, come on. This show here, ladies and gentlemen, is the first day of spring of 2010. Yeah! Winter, you can kiss my ass, baby. You know what I mean? You all know Nick Carter.
Terrible edit.
Know what I mean?
Know what I mean? And then it just stops.
You don't like it, Jimmy?
No, you're getting people riled up telling old man Winter to kiss your ass.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, stupid. Man. Yeah, man. Yeah.
You know what I mean? You all know Nick Carpinelli, right? Everybody say hi.
Who knows him?
Everybody.
I don't know.
Who's everybody?
Nick Carpinelli.
What's funny is Nick Carpinelli, he works in New Hampshire, and apparently he started in Boston as Scorch's intern. So Scorch likes to make a big deal that this is one of his intern success stories because he's doing middays in New Hampshire.
Wow.
Where Scorch is doing afternoons.
Well, that's
pretty impressive.
Yeah.
You all know Nick Carpinelli, right? Everybody say hi, Nick!
Everybody.
What's up? Nick is our man on the couch, our beloved man on the couch, and soon enough, we're going to be doing something.
We're going to be featuring Man on the Couch.
We're going to be doing that Man on the Couch segment soon enough. If you're watching at home, and you would like Nick to bring the portable couch to your town, email us, and Nick will be doing the man on the couch street thing.
There are many things we can do on the couch.
There are a lot of things you can do on the couch. You know what I mean? And some of them we can actually show on the TV show.
Some of them we can't, but we're still up for that.
Some of them will be on YouTube or YouPorn or one of the other things. You know what I mean? So
we'll work that out later.
These guys have no clue that they suck at dick.
That's the beauty of this show.
What rapport?
This is what makes Scorch better than any person that's ever existed.
Yes.
That
he has no clue.
As much as he just bullshits and lies and... he thinks, like, he's the definition of delusions of grandeur.
Yeah.
Like, he believes every bit of bullshit that he says.
Oh, yeah.
He thinks he's awesome.
He thinks this is huge.
The audience is standing.
Do you think? He would tell me in Syracuse that when he was on afternoons on K-Rock, he used to go to the mall and he had to stop going because people from the second tier in the mall would be leaning over the rail and yelling, Scorch, Scorch.
Were they? Really?
I mean, he was recognized once while I was in Syracuse working with him. And he had this line that he always gave at restaurants or anytime anybody asked him. The girl comes up to him and goes, hey, aren't you, because his voice is distinctive, and hey, aren't you on the radio? And he goes, no, I'm sitting right here.
Oh, that was his line.
And he did it every time. That was followed up by the girl saying, yeah, you're on K-Rock, right? And Scorch had to say, no, that I used to be, but now I'm on...
I'm on PFG TV.
You think he believes that no one is saying hi to him in public because he's so famous they just want to leave him alone?
So, he's the type, like, people, like, kind of just look at him when he walks in. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he knows who I am. Right, look at me.
Don't go up to him. He's eating.
Let's move on with PFG TV, our old friend Scorch. Scorch starts his weird news segment.
Yes. Weird news is one of his go-to bits.
And, like douche or dressing.
And Sam, the sarcastic son of a bitch, writes, in which he reads news stories and gives no punchlines.
he just reads the story.
Before we do that, though, why don't we get into our segment that we call Weird News,
Weird News. Vail, Colorado.
What the fuck?
Was that supposed to be like Weird Science?
Yes. Was he ripping off Paul Schaefer there?
He uses all his radio drops on the show.
Uh-huh.
Like half of the drops he uses on this show, he was doing in Syracuse on the radio.
All right,
this is what's awful about this show. Besides the fact that he has an office chair, he has a fucking desk. It looks like something that your grandmother has in the beginning of her apartment to put a Hummel on.
Yeah, like right by the front door of her apartment.
Very
you'd put this against the wall.
With a doily.
And put Hummels and a doily. Yeah.
Yeah, it's terrible. His desk is terrible.
Mark from New Hampshire. We got all the Scorch fans checking in. Mench Vegas checking in. Yes, Mark. Yes, Mark.
Boys, happy birthday.
Douche addressing.
Hi. This guy is such a hack. His editing is terrible on the PFG.
Yeah,
and then
you
go to his radio show and you get his brain cell stimulator.
He makes it
sound like he has a screener, but he doesn't have the screener. He records it on the commercial break, introduces their name, and then half the time they pick up the call and he's already saying hello to him. Like he doesn't know who it is.
What's brain cell stimulator? He's been doing it for years.
Yeah.
It's his go-to bit. All it is a trivia question. And he just asks it. He goes, you know, a study says that guys think about this 90% of the time. So you think it's sex, but it's actually food or something like that.
Oh, my God.
And then he plays the music or he goes to commercials and he answers the phones himself.
Yeah.
And then he comes back, he records the calls, and he goes, all right, Sam, pick up line 3. And then he plays the recording, so it sounds like Sam the intern is picking up line 3.
Picking up line 3, and then a lot of times he just blows it by...
And he won't remember where he started the recording. So, like, he'll go, Sam, pick up line 3. And then the recording will say, all right, Sam, and then the recording will say it again.
Fucking Scorch rules.
Do you think he has a good show?
I love Scorch's show. He also does the... because he doesn't have a screener, so he asks the caller what their name is, and then he'll introduce them by name when he comes back as if there was a screener, which, to his credit, he said that you two invented.
What was it?
Giving the name before you pick up the call.
Opie and Anthony first.
Oh, wow. So, a little credit from Scorch. Oh,
thank you.
But Scorch, you took Feels for Meals from him.
Please,
so
please tell everyone you don't know us.
It's a give and please. He always tells people it's a give and take.
What a
you
terrible.
You take his bits and he takes
yeah, you hear this, Jimmy?
The give and take?
Sam told us that years ago. That Scorch goes that we've been just trading bits over the years.
He
with
tells
each
people,
other. Oh, my God. Don't do this, Scorch.
Instead of telling people that you took Doucher Dressing, his bit, and goofed on it.
We did it as a goof.
He tells people that you took the bit.
Yeah.
That you do. They took Doucher Dressing.
Yeah. I'm proud to say that Opie and Anthony do Doucher Dressing. You know, we trade bits.
All right, Scorch, try this bit.
When we were in Syracuse and he was moving to New Hampshire,
yeah,
he told me 3 months before he was moving to New Hampshire that he was going there. It was done. He knew in 3 months I'm moving. He told I was a free intern, just, and I was coming back to New York anyway. His sidekick that was counting on him to make a living, he told him the night before their last show,
oh, by the way, Friday, that's our last show. I'm moving to New Hampshire on Monday.
Thanks.
Why did he tell him last minute? He didn't want to take him, or why did he do that?
Well, he wasn't taking him.
They probably didn't have a budget to bring Scorch's guys.
Oh, I mean, they paid Scorch bare bones, so they weren't taking his sidekick to New Hampshire, and he didn't want to. Instead, and this, he told his sidekick while he knew that he was going to New Hampshire that he was sending out their tapes and not to worry about anything.
I would listen to Scorch.
Think he was sending their tapes out?
Not to one person.
I would listen to Scorch every fucking day.
Who isn't?
And now he's going to play this audio, see? He loved me.
Yeah, I've gone home and listen. He's streaming.
Right.
So if you're bored in the afternoons, you got to just turn him on for 15 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Great.
Catch a little Scorch.
All right, let's do the weird news thing without the punchlines.
Weird news. Vail, Colorado, neighbors noticing an unusual amount of traffic going in and out of Charles Guadalupe's house.
Well, it was Charles specializing in.
Charles was specializing in, actually, it's funny, he has no love for the lies. Welcome mat on his house says, don't come back without a warrant. They came back with a warrant, and he got busted for cocaine distribution. Stupid bastard.
A guy got busted in Colorado?
That's weird.
What's up? What the fuck is weird about that?
Be more funny.
That's not weird
news. This is going great.
It's like, you know how Leno does headlines?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is like that.
But Leno pumps it up with a little punchline.
And there's a punchline and there's something like
brings
weird,
it all together.
Ironic,
sure,
quirky about the story.
I actually think
double entendre, something.
Leno saw Scorch do weird news and stole it and started doing headlines.
Yeah.
Scorch and his sidekick. Oh,
this is TMGTV, the podcast.
It's like Tippy Tom.
I've never heard two people with worse chemistry.
Yeah. There's nothing there between these two.
Terrible.
Right. There's a track on here later that really.
Well, why don't we try this one? Scorch tells an interesting story with a killer punchline.
This is part
and
of the
I
weird
would assume
news
that
segment.
The punchline is not a punchline or killer.
I mean, it's a pretty good joke.
Interesting story, and this is a true thing. This past weekend, I hosted, I'm a ring announcer for mixed martial arts, MMA. This kid the other day, 26 seconds into the fight, the ring girl stood next to me, like, he's running away, and I'm too busy looking at the ring girls. I wasn't looking at the fight. 26 seconds into it, this kid ran out of the ring. I've never seen anything like that before in my life. The kid ran. This is on my mom's life. True story. 26 seconds in, the ref said, we're going to call it ref stoppage. It's really called something like afraid to fight or fear of the fight. But the referee didn't want to embarrass the kid. And I think in this situation, MMA must have stood for move my ass. Because this kid was like, wow.
Holy shit. I know.
No. And you have to...
Keep fucking that chicken.
Holy shit.
That's funny. I'm funny.
He had to keep reiterating that it was a true story.
Yeah. Well, the awkwardness of the whole thing is that, like we said, there's like 11, 12 people sitting in the studio audience.
Yeah.
So there's deafening silence. He can see every face.
Yeah.
Just looking at him and just staring and not laughing. God.
And he must have seen people looking like, are you kidding? You ran out of the ring, so he had to go, true story, on my mother's life.
Yeah, somebody was pointing at him going, no, that's got to be a lie. That can't be true.
I was only joking.
Yeah. Wow.
That story is not interesting on any level.
None level.
It's called fear of fighting.
And MMA stands for what?
Move my ass.
Move my ass.
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
Okay, terrific.
Does he think of these things at all before he says them?
Yes.
I do too.
He writes.
Nothing.
He's a great writer, Jimmy.
He writes.
Oh, shit, he's going to use that sound clip now, too.
He used to try out lines on me on his sidekick and then do them on the air,
even though we'd tell him. Please tell me you fake laughed.
I always did. His sidekick would get so pissed off because he'd be like, Scorch, that's terrible. And I would every single time go, actually, dude, that's kind of funny. The listeners are going to like that one.
Would you think it was funny?
Oh, my.
I love it.
You thought it was terrible?
It was always awful. His sidekick would be looking at me like, you're fucking me here, man.
That's great.
Because Scorch would believe you?
And he would believe me, and he would do it with such gusto on the air.
Would it get a laugh?
Never.
Well, we move on, Anthony, with Scorch ending weird news with some trouble from the crowd.
What?
Yeah, like...
Does he have to handle hecklers or something?
No, I think he just... This is early in the show, and he's already getting a little frustrated that the crowd's not going with him on everything.
Yeah, huh?
They're all checking their iPhones.
Yeah, waiting for the band to come on.
Texting, yeah.
Texting.
And finally, if you're going to go to a Kmart to get supplies for your meth lab, there's two things. A, don't shoplift. And B, leave the meth lab at home. This guy, Justin Hill of...
Well, wait a minute. Wouldn't you bring the meth lab?
What?
You can't just move a meth lab around.
But he goes, if you're going to get supplies for your meth lab at Kmart, A, don't shoplift. B, leave your meth lab at home.
So where do you think this story's going?
I have no idea, but probably nowhere. That's what I would
think.
That's
your guess.
Nowhere.
Yeah.
This guy, Justin Hill of Warsaw, Indiana, originally just charged with shoplifting, but he's not that bright. So he says, he told the cops, okay, my ID is in my van, can I go get it? No problem. The cops went over to him, went over to the van with the dude. Of course, his van doubles as his meth lab. His van doubles as his meth lab, everybody! Well, this is like the toughest big crowd I've ever seen.
Yeah, this is the biggest crowd, yet the toughest.
The toughest.
Where were you expecting a laugh?
Yeah, what was...
You gave away the punchline, asshole.
Scorch is reading the news stories without writing a punchline. And just figured at the end of the news story is where everybody would just get...
Now, you go... Now, really, let me think about this.
This is infuriating.
You sit there, you're telling a story, you go, so the guy said my license is in the truck.
Yeah.
So they went over there, and they opened up the door, and the guy had a meth lab in the back of his truck.
Period.
And now he's expecting, like,
what?
Applause and like, woo! Yes. And when he didn't get it, he was upset.
He said meth lab home and
yeah, leave the meth lab at home. So he started the story with
the punchline.
This is what he did. He goes, you know, there's a couple of Jews and they're bar owners. And they walk into a bar and they're the owners of that establishment.
Right.
Yeah, tough crowd.
Hey, tough. The best part is he says this is our biggest crowd. I wouldn't brag about that because opening the show, it sounds like 10, 11 people.
When you just hear individual claps.
Right. You don't want to acknowledge that you have a big crowd.
You can hear the one person chuckling.
Right.
That means it's not a big crowd.
Right.
Scorch.
Crowd I've ever seen.
Yeah, this is the biggest crowd, yet the toughest.
The toughest. So he's facing 20 years for manufacturing and another 5 years for just being dumb. And that is weird news for today.
By the way, the weird news bed.
Holy shit.
I can guarantee you it came from a Prep Burger service. It's not an original.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You don't think it's an original?
Prep Burger? It came from Prep Burger. It came from a Morning Jock prep page.
Well, guys, we're listening to Scorch's PFG TV show. And in this next clip, Scorch brags about all his viewers.
This is my favorite clip of the entire show.
Wow. Oh, really?
Okay. This is...
So we should have saved it for last.
No, I mean, I put them in order of the way they broadcast for integrity.
Okay.
But
integrity and these clips. Yeah. Stop.
This clip, this is Scorch. This is the true...
All right.
This is what Scorch is. This is Scorch.
This defines him.
Absolutely.
Better. Welcome back to Scorch's PFG TV, everybody. Live on my network television in 26 gazillion homes.
It's not live.
And by the way, just so you know, we've reached our 90th city, coast to coast on cable as well. So welcome to city number 90. You know who you are. And welcome to the London, England folks as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's going to
be kind of
cool.
They've been on board since what, about 6 or 8 months ago?
Yeah, London jumped on board a little while ago. So the show is definitely worldwide.
Hold on.
Whoa! Oh, my.
Wait.
Hold on.
You don't say
hold on.
Who you are. You mention the city.
City.
Hold on,
I got it.
Why would they know?
You're a liar! Goddamn liar!
Shenanigans!
It's not network TV.
No, it's paid on one station.
See, he doesn't have 90 cities. He has one city.
One city, and it's Manchester, New Hampshire, and it's not London, England, either.
He has 0.09 cities. He has actually less than one. He has a suburb.
So we got England on board about 6 months ago. Was it about 6 months ago?
You know why? Because he got a call from one guy who went, I like your show. And he went, oh, it must be over in London.
On board.
But this is what he used to do. When Kevin Straley was working with XM, he would tell Paulie and me, Paulie is sidekick, that he had these long conversations with Kevin. Uh-huh. They came from the same hometown. He made up details of the conversations that he had. And every 3 months, he told us
the same
that 3 months later, he would be broadcasting on XM.
Yeah.
Always he would tell us that. In August, he said it would be Christmas. In Christmas, he said they're holding off till March. So March, he said summer.
He comes off like a compulsive liar.
Just lies.
He really does come off like a compulsive liar.
He invents in his head what he would like to happen and where he would like to be.
Yeah.
And then he pretends it's reality.
So PFG TV is on in 90 cities.
And London.
And London.
The sad part is, when we were working with Scorch at AF, they got rid of him to bring in Rocco.
Yeah,
I want to listen to Scorch over Rocco.
Oh yeah.
Well, they wanted what, hamburgers and
yeah,
he was pizza.
He was pizza.
Yeah,
that famous fucking douche line from the dumb PD who's doing nothing.
We want ham. People have a flavor for hamburger, and you're garbage.
And you're a garbage plate from the Tahoe's.
What he's banking on is the fact national show like this one won't expose anyone to PFG TV because. People listening to this all over the country.
All over.
Since nobody has seen the show, obviously he can't be in 90 cities because there would have been one out of 90 that would have known that the show was on in their city.
Right.
At least.
All right, well. It's pretty obvious.
It's amazing.
That was a bunch. That was a very.
It's just a lie.
Douchey clip right there.
Wow.
I say douche.
Douche or liar.
Douche addressing.
Douche
or
liar.
I said that was a douche.
Douche.
Scorch does dating site disasters. Another one of his bits where he shows pictures of people and makes observations that are obvious and not terribly funny.
I want to do this thing called dating site disasters.
Oh,
these are actual pictures of people. That, yes, exactly. These are actual pictures of people that were on dating sites. And it's like, you got to kind of wonder. I'm a single guy, but you got to kind of wonder. Hey, look at these people, you know. For instance, let's go to our first picture here. Check this guy out, okay? His site, his headline said, hello, I'm a serial killer. I mean, look at this guy. This guy's like, call my number, give me a call, I'll meet you outside, and they'll find your body in 13 different pieces in a lake. So, hello, I'm a serial
killer. Excellent punchline.
Wow, that is...
You see how he repeated it a few times
because
he started panicking because
did the crowd go to the bathroom or something?
No, they were sitting there watching
still there.
Him.
As he didn't go to get popcorn or something?
Said hello, I'm a serial killer.
Did the whole crowd decide to have a cigarette outside at the same time?
It's everything. It's the voice, the delivery, the material.
It's fucking terrible.
Nothing is working here.
Why is he saying I'm a serial killer and then just listing serial killer things?
I'm a serial killer again.
You can find a body chopped up in 13 pieces in a lake. I'm a serial killer.
Is this enraging, Jimmy?
This guy's good.
Oh, Chip likes him.
Found a bunch of body parts.
So he just shows a picture and then obviously...
He's saying that this picture came from a dating site. This man's a serial killer. He's on a dating site.
A little crazy.
It's nuts.
He was crazy looking.
I guess.
Scorch shows another picture and displays the chemistry between him and his sidekick.
If you liked his chemistry, then him and his sidekick
had. Oh, good. Magic.
Wait till you hear this.
Magic happens.
Yes.
Next up, it would appear that you got to do some acid or something, because this girl is banging a, what do you call the little animal there? A Pikachu, thanks. And so she says, what a trip it is to have relations with me and a Pikachu. Look at that. So she looks like Kelly Osbourne, too, doesn't she?
No.
You don't think she looks like Kelly Osbourne?
I don't think I've ever seen Kelly Osbourne look...
Nick, put on your dollar store glasses, drink some Cabin Fever. That is Kelly Osbourne.
After Cabin Fever, that would be Kelly... Well, no. It would make it better looking than Kelly Osbourne.
Kelly Kelly Brock.
Okay, there you go. Kelly LeBrock. Absolutely.
Yeah. Kelly LeBrock? Yeah. Is it Kelly LeBrock?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes.
What's the candy company? Is that just Brock's?
Yeah, I don't know.
Hi, five ball. It leads the left center field. It's way back. It may be playable. Cat gonna play. It's gone. A home run. Oh, he caught it. He caught it at the wall.
Yeah.
I'm not sure he was unable to reach it.
No.
No, see.
No, he caught it. That wasn't a home run. That wasn't a single. That wasn't anything. It was an out.
How do you go from Kelly Osbourne to Kelly LeBrock?
No, Kelly Brock.
And then Brock's Brock, right. Candy.
Right. Then
Brock's candy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, because he had Nick to bounce off of.
Gorge.
I heard one guy. I heard one guy uncomfortably laughing in the audience
because he's his competitor.
Just laughing at him.
Wow. Wow, that was really bad. That one.
Listen, 90 cities, London, England, can't be wrong.
And the 90th city, you know who you are.
You know. Because there's a big banner on the TV station that says, we are the 90th city.
Yeah.
Why would anybody know that?
And wouldn't he have had a party for the 50th city?
Or like the second.
The second.
Why don't we, well, that might have been a fluke or something. So
yeah.
We got Scorch trying another line here. This will, this will be the last clip from PFG TV.
Aww. For today.
For today. That's right. Oh, we're bringing back this segment.
Big time.
Scorch or douche?
Douche.
Both.
Every time.
Exactly. Yeah, both. All of the above would be the answer.
Next up, how about this one? Let's go on. This one just basically says, hello, I'm a loser. Except he says it like
that
this.
That should be the intro to his show.
Loser. Date me. Date me. Any comments, anybody? No?
That clip should be in your replay. Any comments, anybody? No?
Oh, God.
How do you bomb on a retard noise?
Please, I can't.
Dude, please can we hear that last clip again?
Please.
Any comments? Anyway, that's such a sign of
obviously
desperation.
The guy didn't look too good in his picture. He looked like a loser, so Scorch had to point out the obvious.
He was trying to do the tarred voice a little too much.
Next up, how about this one? Let's go on. This one just basically says, hello, I'm a loser. Except he says it like this. Oh, loser. Date me. Date me. Any comments, anybody? No?
And it's out of here! Or is it? No, it's off the wall. My mistake. I thought the ball was gone, but apparently not. Right center field. McLouth is back to the track. He leaps at the wall, and it is gone.
Yeah.
It just cleared.
Yep.
No.
What are
they're saying two. They're saying it's a double. It went just under the wall.
Oh, I love that one because he goes, what are they saying?
What are they saying? You're the one that said it.
You're the one that says the stuff. Wow, that's...
So at least you know your radio brethren from back in the days.
Good still to know doing that he's well. Alive
prospering.
Well. Yeah, he is prospering.
He's flourishing.
In market 282 or whatever it is.
And he spends so much time on his show trying to convince people to be his sponsors. Like he sells them and says, you know, just so you know, it's not like you're just getting a commercial because there are no commercials because it's paid time. He says, you'll actually be part of the PFG family, which is worth so much more. He's not paying his staff with the money. He's not buying things for the set. He's putting it in his pocket and keeping it.
We should get an advertiser boycott going.
Boycott PFG TV. They made fun of retards.
Yeah, exactly. We won't buy your product. Poor Scorch.
He rules.
He does rule.
He's so bad.
He's the best, though.
It's just horrible.
He's been doing it for so many years.
Yeah, it's like, how could you talk so much and be so terrible at it?
Date me.
No. It's not funny. There's no rapport.
There's no irony.
Anything.
And that lump on the couch with him.
But yeah. The beauty of Scorch is he doesn't know.
He
thinks he's Letterman. In his mind, he's Letterman or Leno.
Combination of the two, actually.
He thinks he's like the best
of both. Yeah, I think so. He told me when he found out I was a wrestling fan that he got Triple H into the WWE.
Oh, yeah.
He let me know.
Oh, we heard that years ago.
Yeah, it was fungible.
We actually asked Triple H that because we had it with that rumor, and he laughed.
He didn't know who he was.
He openly laughed.
Who? What? What's a Scorch?
You guys want to do some PFG TV today or what? PFG TV?
Of course.
As long as we don't poke fun at it.
Yeah, only if we're serious.
Where's Sam?
Well, we put this together for Colin Quinn that was supposed to be in today because he's a big fan of Scorch.
Yeah.
A guy that we worked with many years ago.
Scorch.
We worked well over 10 years ago with Scorch, maybe 12,
at the wonderful
13 years ago. Yeah. And then you fast forward a little bit, and our own Sam Roberts interned for Scorch up there in Syracuse.
Not amazing.
So we have a connection.
Work out like that.
That's where I learned to do radio.
From Scorch.
Yes. Jesus Christ. I'm so sorry.
No wonder you're doing radio like this.
I'm Sam Roberts.
I'm Sam Roberts.
Scorch does a voice.
This is Lady Gaga.
Scorch does a voice. He's very successful.
Yeah. Kingdom of what?
Well, he's not doing the Kingdom of Nakedness
what
anymore.
What am I now?
He's
Naked
doing
Militia.
PFG, and he's doing the Lumpa Nation.
I think, what is Lumpa Nation?
I think Lumpa is like the station, like across the station is the Lumpa Nation. So he does the Lumpa Afternoon Nation.
What does that mean?
I don't know. It's L-U-M-P-A.
Holy shit. He just doesn't fucking see.
What does Lumpa mean? It has to mean something.
But he doesn't seem to be doing naked or nude things anymore.
Hey, no, can't do that. FCC, baby.
Disappointment. What does PFG stand for?
Pretty fucking great.
Oh, that's right.
And I thought it was.
And, no, I was corrected. Yeah, it's
And you cut up another one of his TV shows.
Pretty
and
fucking god-awful.
How many markets is he in?
He's in 90 and then also in London, 90. England.
Yeah, 90 markets and London, England.
I like when he welcomed the new markets, he wouldn't name them. He goes, you know who you are.
You know who you are, because I don't. Because there aren't any.
Safe to say he's not in 90 markets.
Safe
and
to
not
say
in England.
That the only place he's being broadcast is in the pay slot on Saturdays at midnight on the My Network in Manchester, New Hampshire.
And there's the Lumpa Nation logo. What does
Lumpa
mean?
It's all people with cancer tumors.
Lumpa. Yeah, Lumpa.
By the way, I'm going to sue the logo.
Yeah.
It's a cog, much like my stupid one.
Yes. No, and it's got my name Lumpa, and my last name is shit.
Lumpa shit.
I think if you're a fan of Rock 101 in New Hampshire, Manchester, you're part of the Lumpa Nation.
All right, it says a Lumpa created by New Hampshire's Rock 101 is someone who works hard every day and has a boss but needs a break.
It's a blue collar worker, Anthony.
I'm a Lumpa.
But why Lumpa?
It's like sometimes you
Lumpa.
You turn a radio on after a hard day's work and you just forget about it.
I guess because you're treated like a lump of shit.
Yeah.
So they're just saying you're a Lumpa.
What?
I would assume. Because the boss man! It's the boss man! Or an Oompa Lumpa.
No, I don't think there's any Oompa.
Well, you're treated like a Lumpa.
Yes, I'm sure. And then Scorch comes out and they say, doopity douche.
I've got another bad bit for you.
Lumpa, doopity dee. You'll never get more than one market ye.
At one point, you saying Scorch bad bits reminded me that he did, in an effort to get people to get tickets to come see PFG TV live in the studio audience, he announced that he is bringing back the Wheel of Meat to television.
Oh, Wheel of Meat.
All right, let's get into this. So the first clip here is new PFG TV. Scorch starts PFG TV with a little weather humor.
Yeah, a little joke to start things off, you know.
All right.
Wow.
What a fine, fine night for Scorch's PFG TV, because the day we are taping this show, after having something like 3,000 inches of rain, the sun came out today, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it felt good, man.
And for the rest of this here week, it's supposed to be in the 60s to near 70, which if you're in New England, 70 and at this time of the year,
yeah, we deserve that.
Freaking
absolutely.
Thumbs up. So, Mother Nature, it's about time you stop being what I like to call a spag. Thank you very much, you know.
A spag, which is like a douchebag.
Thank you very much.
Spag.
What's a spag?
And he expected big laughs out of that. He goes, you know what I like to call? Now, hold on, here it comes. A spag.
A shebag?
Shebag. Shebag.
Shebag.
Douche.
Which I think is douchebag.
Yes.
So you put an apostrophe spag.
Yes.
The apostrophe takes care of the do part.
Oh.
And then you're just a spag. It's kind of a cool way to say douchebag.
And then you say, you know, when nobody laughs. Because
well, that's
you're trying
just,
to
that covers,
transition
that
to
covers
the
up, covers up the silence.
Right. Scorch.
Wait, wait. Yeah, we
like freaking
absolutely.
Thumbs up. So, Mother Nature, it's about time you stop being what I like to call a... spag. Thank you very much,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, you know.
People here are calling Scorch an agate.
Oh, that's not fair. I would say it shows it, but that actually works.
Yes. It's just some it.
It's
a hit.
That's not right.
The show is a hit.
that's
in that
it.
Context,
let's
get
not
it?
Play oh, anymore. Sorry.
You that's think that's, no. That's enough?
Yeah, that's plenty.
I mean, that's only the first 30 seconds of PFG TV.
Well, we find out what's going on with his crew.
Yeah, I mean, because, you know...
And we get a taste of the unmatchable chemistry between Nick and Scorch.
Well, Jim said last time that he loved the chemistry between Scorch and his man on the couch, Nick.
Right.
And so right here is a little example. Scorch starts the show trying to display the personalities that he's brought along with him for the ride.
Oh.
And you get to see exactly why these guys get to be on television.
All right, let's take a listen.
Y'all know our pal, the man of the couch. Give it up for Nick. Everybody say, hi, Nick.
Hi, Nick.
No, you can do better than that.
Eight people.
You don't get everybody to yell when there's only eight people there.
Oh.
You should ask everybody to keep it down a little. You can hear individual voices.
Yes. Never good.
Nick.
Hi, Nick.
No, you can do better than that. Everybody say, hi, Nick.
Hi, Nick.
What's up, PFG Cycle? See, that's a little bit better, you know. And you all know DJ Furious over there, right?
Wow, what a crowd. You can hear the individual claps.
It seems like you have a lot of enemies today, Mr. Furious.
Apparently so.
He's very understated today.
That's what it is, you know. So what's up with you guys? What's going on with my crew? Anything? What's up with you guys? Everything good? What's up? What's up? Let's start with Nick. These are always the fun stories. What's up in your life?
Oh, no, man. You got to check my my Facebook page for that.
Oh,
I'm not giving it up right now. No.
Dude, why would you on a show?
Yeah.
What is so? What's your Facebook page address so people can do?
Never
that?
Mind, man. I'm not going to go there. I got so much going on. I would need like so many dollars in therapy to get through it.
Oh, I bet.
What the hell happened?
It just fell apart.
That guy fucking stinks.
What the fuck happened?
That's my favorite part of the show now. Scorch always. I don't know why he gets this idea that Nick's going to have something for him.
Scorch nothing.
Constantly goes to Nick for something, and every time Nick. Says,
never delivers.
No, I'm not going to go there.
Is that tears in your eyes?
Sam's crying.
First Nick made this reaction, like, whoa. And Scorch goes, oh, good one. Okay, what's your stories? And Nick says, well, I'm not going to tell you. It's on my Facebook. And then Scorch says, oh, you have a Facebook? And Nick says, yeah. And Scorch says, okay, what's your Facebook? And Nick says, I'm not going to tell you.
I'm not going to tell you. So why did he go
to can we go back to that? Can you?
Oompa, loompa, loompa-dee-doo. Let's count my audience. One and two.
Doopa-dee-dee. If you look closely, you'll see number three. Oh no! Wait, that was a mirror.
Can we count how many times Scorch is let down in that clip? Sam's onto something.
He's let down.
Nick is just he realizes
Nick is a fucking albatross.
He realizes
out to dry.
He realizes the first one was a dead end, so he tried another way. That's a dead end. I think there's three or four dead ends.
Why would you pick this guy as your couch guy?
All right, listen. He's just trying to get something from Nick. How many times has he failed?
Y'all know our pal, the man on the couch. Give it up for Nick. Everybody say, hi, Nick.
Hi, Nick.
No, you can do better than that. Everybody say, hi, Nick.
Hi, Nick.
What's up, PFG
G-Cycle.
There you go. See, that's a little bit better, you know. And you all know DJ Furious over there, right?
No. That means no.
Whatever.
It seems like you have a lot of enemies today, Mr. Furious.
Apparently so.
He's very understated today. Yeah. That's what it is, you know. So what's up with you guys? What's going on with my crew? Anything? What's up with you guys? Everything good? What's up? What's up? Let's start with Nick. These are always the fun stories. What's up in your life?
Oh, no, man. You got to check my Facebook page for that.
All right. Dead end number one.
I'm not giving it up right now, no.
You have a Facebook page?
I do.
What is so? What's your Facebook page address so people can do?
Never
that?
Mind, man. I'm not going to go
there. Dead end.
I got so much going on. I would need like so many dollars in therapy to get through it.
So many dead ends.
He can't get an answer out of his bestest guy on the couch.
That was the worst unraveling of a joke. I would need so many dollars to get
so
through
many
it.
Dollars is to get through the thingy.
But like his whole thing is like, oh, wait till I tell you, and then Scorch is like, what? And then he goes nothing
every time.
Yeah.
Oh, nothing. I got something. What is it? Ah, nothing.
Yeah, well, come on, asshole.
And he keeps inviting him back to sit on the couch.
Sit on the couch. Like he's Carson. The fuck?
Yes.
Oh,
Jesus.
All right, Scorch promotes that he's getting
Jack
back
subpar.
In the dog cage this year for Pause for a Cause.
You remember Pause for a Cause has a history on this program.
Yes.
He stinks. He's so bad.
Who, Nick Cannon finale?
Oh, all of them, that whole crew.
Jack Subpar.
Yeah, Pause for a Cause is the event where Scorch sleeps in a dog cage,
and one of our listeners threw yellow paint on him.
Yeah.
So he had to stop doing pissed. Pause for a Cause for a while.
He was so pissed.
And he's finally bringing it back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope no one throws yellow paint on him this year.
Oh, please. All right, it's a good cause.
He's announcing that he's back in the cage, Ant, after a few years not doing it because of one of our listeners.
Back in the cage.
Speaking of dogs and animals, on June...
Was he even talking about dogs and animals?
Was.
He previewed that, and I hate to spoil anything, but he previewed that coming up later in the show would be his segment called Animals on Drugs.
Sounds funny.
And then he said, speaking of animals and dogs...
Speaking of dogs and animals, on June the 6th or the 7th of this year, I will be going back into the cage for another week. Yeah, thank you much.
They're clapping. I think it means prison, and he won't be broadcasting.
And basically what I do is I live in a cage, in a dog's cage, right? 24 hours a day, I live in this cage till I raise a certain amount of money for local animal shelters. And my
$6.
Goal this year is to raise $30,000 cash for the local animal shelters.
She's lying.
If everybody watching right now will put away a buck a week until the time comes, by the time I get into the
cage,
when
is it, 2025?
And we're going to have our 30 grand, no problem. So,
oh my God.
No problem. No if everyone problem. Watching puts away a buck a week until when?
Until June 6th.
He'll have $30,000. We could do some quick math here. Bullshit.
If every listener he has does that, he's still short by $28,000.
Yeah, at the end of the week, he'll lie and say he has $30,000.
Yeah, we hit the mark, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. I want to say, but you're the real heroes. You're the people that did it. You know, I just stayed in the cage.
They poured yellow paint on.
He would need 3,333 listeners.
3,330. No way.
No.
He's got that.
It's 9 weeks away.
He doesn't even have the 30.
No.
He doesn't.
Guy's done.
Well, he has three.
Oh, yes.
So now he needs 3,330.
Yeah, more.
Turn my mic off.
Well,
okay. All right. No, that's all right, man. I like the fact you got up, even though you humiliated yourself and stopped the show,
trap
at least
dog.
You went up there and took a swing at it.
Trap dog.
Yeah.
Good trap dog.
Exactly.
PFG continues with weird news.
I know you guys love the weird news.
Yeah. In the meantime, though, why don't we get right into our first segment that we like to call weird news.
Some are fun and some deranged. Stories
nice.
That are very strange. Weird news.
Oh, so you thought getting texting while driving was bad. 23-year-old Rachel Allen of London, England, led police on a high-speed chase rather than caught up to her.
They found out why she was acting so erratically. She was shooting up heroin as she was driving. Okay? They only stopped her for the texting. And as it turns out, she was texting her friend saying, I'm shooting up heroin. And the cops are after me. What am I going to do? So obviously she can predict the future because she's now facing 10 years in prison. So good for her.
Why predict the future?
None of it made any sense.
Obviously she can predict the future. And why would she text her friend, I'm high on heroin.
Yeah, I'm doing heroin.
And no one has ever texted that.
No. I'm driving and shooting her. Like,
how do you do that, by the way?
He described the news story, and then instead of writing a joke, he said that she was texting the news story that he had just described.
Right.
So she predicted the future.
He said she predicted the future. Oh, my God. Oh, he's off his rocker.
Yeah. Well, he's got more weird news.
Weird news.
And then the next three stories I have are great because they're all about passed out drunk people. And we all have been there and or know some people that do that. So the next time you passed out drunk behind the wheel of a stolen car, take your punishment and leave it at that. This guy from Cincinnati, Ohio, named Damon Bailey, he was getting his fine handed to him at the at court. He looked at the arresting officer and said, I'm going to kill you. No more drunk driving charges for Damon. He's in jail for 13 years for threatening the life of the cop. So that's the, yeah, you know what I mean?
No one gets 13 years for saying, I'm going to kill you.
I'm sure he got something else going on.
And then he's a fucking moron.
Danny popped up the video of him, and that studio is hysterical.
Great. P.G. Allen had a fucking better stage set when he was shitting bananas all over the fucking place.
Did you notice the PFG laptop?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's fantastic.
It's terrific. He's got an uplifting story to end weird news.
And we have one more drunk driving story. Here you go. Another drunk story. Not a good idea if you're drunk driving and you stick your head out the window to get sick, right? 22-year-old, this is an awful story.
I think I've seen this.
22-year-old Stephen Campaign of Clearwater, Florida, didn't want to get anything on his car. So when he put his head out the window as he was driving to get sick, he put his head really out the window and he hit a light post and he basically got decapitated as he was driving. So, yeah. Good news is, thank you.
That's it.
Bad news is he did get decapitated. The good news is he got no vomit or anything on the car, so it all worked out, wasn't it? There you go. That's today's installment of Weird News.
There you go. Yeah.
What was that clip you played? Well, that's a jingle, a little like jingle thing that he's had at least in Syracuse, because he used to use it all the time when I was working with him.
The ha 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 thing?
It just goes, you are an idiot. Ha 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 ha.
Oh my God.
You love the Scorched, don't you?
I love him so much. He used to play that clip and I would just laugh.
Dude.
And he thought I was laughing at how funny he was.
Ryan, and you were just laughing.
So of course I was.
Such a wise ass. Scorch starts a new segment called Animals on Drugs. He starts with a picture of a cat next to a bag of weed.
Yeah, this Animals on Drugs, it's like, remember the last time we listened to PFG TV, his segment was called Dating Site Disasters, where he showed pictures of people from dating sites?
Right.
This is called Animals on Drugs, where he shows pictures of animals who may or may not be on drugs.
And we have to guess?
No, he shows the picture, and then he makes...
Here, Sam.
This is pretty much...
some tissues for your fucking tears, you weirdo.
This is pretty much like the sensation that's sweeping the nation about cats on the internet.
Right, except it's pictures of animals who might be on drugs, and then he says things about them.
All right, let's listen.
Why don't we talk about animals on drugs? This is something, and I love my animals, you know what I mean? So it's nothing bad about animals, but a lot of people have taken animals, pictures of animals while they're on drugs. For instance, we've got our first one. This thing right here, this is called Feline Fun. Okay, Feline Fun. Now the worst part is, honest to God, that lucky SOB cat is good. Look at the grass in there. Look at that butt in that bag. Come on now. Even Joe in the booth is like, yeah, man, I hear you. That looks like some good stuff. And the cat is like saying, I think I know where you got that from.
What's that funny smell? What? How much do you think that stuff costs, Nick?
I know it's not a funny sound.
I'm not even going to venture to guess.
Oh, sorry.
Nick.
I'm not going to give us an educated guess on that one.
Nick still hasn't contributed.
The best part, you have to play that clip again, because the best part is at the end, where he realizes that Nick has failed him again, because he says, I thought you were going to give an educated guess on that one.
I'm not even going to try.
I'm not even going to try.
He's like, Scorch, not even going to try to help you out. Why my man on the couch, helping me out all the time. Here's my man.
I think I know where you got that from. What's that funny smell? What? How much do you think that stuff costs, Nick? I'm not even going to venture to guess. I figured you'd give us an educated guess on that one.
Oh my God.
Nick is just laughing at him.
Holy shit.
What the fuck is up with
Nick? What a disaster.
Nick is valueless on that show.
He doesn't want to give any opinions. He doesn't want to answer
really
any
is.
Questions.
No.
Doesn't want to lead
Holy
Scorch
shit.
Into any conversation.
He wants to stop Scorch from all conversation.
That's unbelievable. The next is a picture of a dog that looks happy, so this is what Scorch has to say about it.
Go on, look for the next one. This one is basically just, look at it. I mean, come on, the dog's just high, and he's happy about it. Look at it. He said, hey. He said, hey, look at me. I am baked. The worst part is he's a male dog, and he has to be high because his master's put a little heart tag on him. And it's like, everybody's going to think I'm a gay dog. I don't like that, man. I'm a straight dog, but I'm high.
Holy shit. Holy shit. Wow.
Because the dog is high, so he's, you know.
Yeah, we got it.
Sir. Okay, I didn't know, because you guys weren't laughing.
This is from PFG TV. Scorch's PFG TV is always looking for new family members. Do you want your company to be featured in millions of homes? Email for details. Millions of homes. Email for details.
Well, Meat Whistle writes, his parents are listening and scorching his birth certificate right now. And Caroline Man writes, Nick is awesome. Is Nick a plant?
What do you mean a plant?
I think actually a plant.
Oh, like a physical plant.
I don't know.
A fern.
Let's say hi to Dave in Massachusetts. Dave.
Nick on that show is like Marvin from Pulp Fiction and should be treated and disposed of as such.
I'm shot in the face. Very good.
I don't know why that didn't get a laugh.
That's Blind Dave, too, man. You should laugh at everything Blind Dave says.
Oh, is it?
Because he's
blind. Dave.
Should run for governor.
He shows a picture of a dog next to some snacks, and this is what Scorch
next
has to say.
Next to snacks.
Yeah, PFG TV.
This next one's a really good one, and it looks almost like one of my dogs, too. This next one's like, anybody got the munchies? Anybody got the munchies? I'll help you out. Munchies. And what are they? Are they like everlasting gobstoppers or something?
Absolutely what they are.
So the munchies with the dog, and we have one more here.
Oh, fuck, man. Just in a disaster loop?
That was Nick's cue to think of something funny, and Nick just goes, yeah, that's absolutely what they are.
So far, that's what he's added to the show.
A yup.
It's a good show. This guy goes from topic to topic. He riffs.
Yeah.
Nick's good.
You think it's good, Chip?
It's great, yeah, because Nick's crazy, man. You know what that guy's going to do.
Yeah.
Scorch is good. Get the animal drugs. The animal's probably high as a kite.
His comments really make the bit, you know?
Right.
Because I'm sure, and we can't see the pictures, but the way he describes it and everything, I get a crystal clear picture, and then the comedy comes.
That's what I figured, because, I mean, granted, this is a visual bit, but he provides so much with his commentary
that
he actually
paints the picture. Munchies,
exactly.
Munchies, hey, look at that, munchies, yeah, right? It's called painting the picture. He does a very good job with that.
True. You can tell he's been in radio for many, many years.
He dips his brush in shit.
Painting.
Jack subpar.
Painting the fucking lid of his toilet with diarrhea.
He mercifully ends the segment with an overexposed picture of a cat sleeping next to a bong.
Oh, I think that's what it was. It was very hard to see because the picture was overexposed.
Really?
It was a bad picture.
Let's see
picture.
What he has to say about the cat next to the bong.
And this is a really good one, too. Look at this. The cat.
Yeah!
You know what I'm saying? Does that not? That, ladies and gentlemen, is what you call a passed-out pussy. Cat. And there you go. Animals on drugs.
as we celebrate, Photoshop is 20 years old this week. Imagine
really?
The guys that invented Photoshop, wow. 20 years old this week. So we're going to be doing a lot more stuff like that. And a lot more fun with just different types of things that we're looking for, you know what I mean, on the show.
On the show.
I forgot. He loves yes. The anniversary and the all that stuff. He once on the air, he said, he got into this kick of doing top 10 lists.
Oh,
I think
wow.
I've told you guys about some of his lists. He got on the air and said, tomorrow is the anniversary of the invention of the jungle gym. And so off the air, his sidekick said, I mean, if you really want to talk about the anniversary of the jungle gym, we should do something stupid, like have our stunt guy do something on a jungle gym, like on a playground.
Mm-hmm.
And Scorch goes, no, we're going to do the top 10 gyms list, including Jim Belushi and other gyms. And his sidekick, Paulie, was trying to figure out why he would do that. And then Scorch left the room, and I had to inform Paulie that Scorch had already told me earlier that the next day was not at all the anniversary of the Jungle Gym. He just wanted an excuse
to read the top 10 gyms. Holy shit, Scorch is a compulsive liar. He's just a compulsive liar. Yes.
Hey, Wayne in Boston, millions of homes. Scorch's PFG TV fan page on Facebook.
Yeah?
300.
Wow.
321 fans.
Oh. And according to his Facebook, it says, according to the PFG TV Facebook, Scorch is giving away pizza to get people in his studio audience.
Yes.
So he gives away pizza?
He promotes that on the air, that there is a free pizza for the audience members, and then he has to mention it several times on the show. And he takes his sponsor breaks.
Millions of homes he gets into.
Right, where he informs the sponsors that they're part of the PFG family if they'll buy time on his show.
Yeah.
And he just talks about tattoo shops and things like that, but he's obviously swindled.
Swindled.
I mean, he's just pocketing the money.
Fuck. Well, that's fantastic. I can't get enough.
Yeah, we'll have to get another one.
I only
one.
Wish Colin was here because he loves
Scorch.
Next week,
we'll get another one. We'll get another one for next week.
I mean, yeah, I have a source now in Manch Vegas that is sending me these.
Manch Vegas, right.
Every week.
It's in Manch Vegas.
We won't miss an episode.
Thank God.
He just taped this?
This was taped March 20th. This was aired March 28th of this year.
Does he do this on purpose?
No.
Someone has to be being forced to do this.
No.
Yeah. You know.
He's thinking of this is his big break. No, he's not being ironic or being bad on purpose or anything. He thinks that he is the shit.
Did he actually say the guys that invented Photoshop are 20 years old today?
I think he
said they started making it when they were born.
Yeah. Yeah, they turned 20. Mm. That's Scorch.
He probably doesn't exactly know what Photoshop is either. Because none of the pictures that he showed had any Photoshopping involved.
No.
It's just a picture.
I didn't need it. I just needed to use the word Photoshop.
Yeah.
So I could do a thing on camera, people. You can do the take pictures. There's Kodak, the family, Polaroid, top 10 cameras, Panaflex.
He once said that he used toothpicks every day. It was his thing. That was one of his visual things, that he always had a toothpick in his mouth. And he told me and Paulie that since he uses toothpicks every day, he told us that he writes off $5,000 worth of toothpicks on his taxes.
On his taxes? I wish Smith & Wesson made toothpicks.
How many toothpicks would that be?
Well, we did the math, and there's no feasible way that.
That's got to be a million toothpicks.
A box that includes hundreds, if not 1,000 toothpicks, costs $2.
Unless every day he just shoves a full box of toothpicks in his mouth and walks around looking all silly.
Like the cigarette guy in the Guinness Book of Records.
And then he spits them out a second later and puts another box in. There's no way $5,000 in toothpicks.
No.
Or is he just a compulsive liar?
Well, there's a couple things going on. Nick in Virginia writes he should give the audience free pistols instead of pizza.
Yeah,
that's not right.
And Jeff in Boston, believe it or not, the MyTV station he's on is available all over the Boston market. I get it where I am, south of Boston.
I don't know how much he's paying for it, but it starts off with the following is a paid program.
Yeah. There's a big difference between how many homes get the station
right.
and how many people watch
or
the show.
In.
Because, you know, I'm sure NBC, when they had Seinfeld on, you know, it was very good. But just because you're on NBC doesn't mean every show was a hit.
Right. Not every single show on the network
was Seinfeld
right.
worthy.
Saturday at Midnight probably did not get the same ratings as Seinfeld.
And anytime you see paid programming, click, you're off.
And PFG is running opposite SNL. So if you want comedy on a Saturday night, you either go SNL or PFG TV.
I think PFG TV.
Saturday Night Lame.
Yeah.
I go PFG every time, Sam.
I would.
Every fucking time.
I got them all on DVD now.
What's up, Colin? You good?
Maury jumping in the
pool.
Oh,
I'm grand. I like coming right in when it's you guys are really hitting the racial stuff.
Hey, yeah.
Well, we got some Scorch for you, so don't worry.
Oh, good.
We got some Scorch.
I want Scorch and... I want to hear Dice Kelly.
Dice Kelly, okay.
Oh, yeah. My request.
You got requests?
And I heard there's a guy that you love.
Who?
That comes in. You have a new guest.
Who? Tell me.
Chipperson or something?
Oh. Chipperson.
I heard he's a real knee slapper.
He's a hoot.
Jimmy says you love Chip.
It's not loving. It's beyond. It's like, it's so... Ugh, it makes me revulsed.
He does it at the cellar, right?
Yes.
It's
disgusting.
Yeah.
But I'm a fan. I can't tell us. I had the whole place cracking up. This is Colin over there. I'm going to write this stuff down. It really makes people sick. I did it for William Stevenson last night.
Oh,
it was like he was punched in the stomach. It's like a physical assault on Collins.
Yeah,
he was
horrified.
It really is an assault.
Yeah.
For the first time, I don't know what to do with that.
Yeah, he's just...
In all these years of radio, it stops me in my tracks.
Yeah, it stops everyone.
I don't know what to do with that. Usually you can work around something. I don't know what to do.
You can keep staring and paint a picture or something.
See? There's nowhere to go with it.
What do you do, Colin? You've been around? What do you do with that? What do you do?
No, you're Chip, you can't do anything with
it. No?
Chip.
Hey, Keith's coming in at 8:30. We should play.
Oh, 8:30. It was 8 o'clock.
Oh, 8 o'clock?
Yeah.
No, Colin was supposed to be 8, Keith at 8:30. I don't know. Whatever. Whenever he shows up is fine, but we got Scorch audio that I definitely want to focus on a little bit before Keith gets here. Because then it's going to get too crowded, and we're not going to be able to get this
audio.
Besides,
Keith sounds like the Black Scorch. Our Scorch. Keith ain't showing up. I saw him last night.
Philly. No? He went back to Philly.
He's just like, what time does this thing come on? I go, I said 8 o'clock. Where is it? I was like, you're not coming. Where is it?
What a dope.
You know how many times we've had him booked on the show and
outside the cellar, where is it?
I know he's got a good gig with Wanda now, but come on, do some radio with us.
Yeah, exactly. Come on.
We can all write ourselves here.
Keith is a bum.
Where's Sam? Because Sam helps us out with the Scorch.
You love Scorch? Sam's worked with Scorch.
Do you want to do this, Colin? You love Scorch, we figured.
I do.
And you know he's doing this this public access TV show now, right?
No.
Oh, yeah. He does a public access TV show. Where he brings the magic that is Scorch to the screen.
That could be good.
And how he does this, he buys time on a station, an infomercial.
Right.
And then sets up a little deck.
But he makes believe that he's just syndicated around the world with his little show out of...
That's what you do.
Out of Manchester.
Let's see what the man's got going.
Scorch.
Oh, he's in Manchester. That's right.
That's right.
Vegas.
Are we explaining this correctly? What else could you add to this for Colin?
Yeah, well, Scorch has... he's syndicated in 90 cities.
90 cities?
What?
That's what he said.
That's what he says.
And also...
See, Scorch is a compulsive liar.
Also, London, England.
London, England, Colin.
Look at grandma's little bureau he's got there.
Yeah.
He's got a little fucking...
That's actually a nice end table. And his staff is completely contribute nothing on it.
Useless.
Nothing.
Except for Nick.
About Manchester, New Hampshire, they have some nice furniture.
They got nice furniture?
Yeah, for that.
We should go antiquing up there, Colin.
We really should.
You and I, man. Let's do this.
Let's do it.
Maybe you bought it at Bernie and Phil's. Oh, Bernie.
I used to love the Bernie and Phil.
That's right, Phil. Dr. Phil, I had a nightmare. What did you dream, Bernie? That I was banging your stretched-out pussy.
Trust me.
On this couch.
You're laughing at Boston. This is very local, Colin.
Please.
Very local. He just did some radio for Framingham.
Right there for fucking Natick. Natick is cracking up.
Natick is just howling right now.
People on Route 9 are crashing their cars.
I can't believe how accurate that is. How about my friend from Medford?
Medford.
You know what, dude? I grew up in Medford, but now I'm in the Big Apple. You know what, dude? Dreams come true. Boom, one day you decide, you know, boom, I'm going to move. I get you
Sales
coffee.
Sales consultants can help them build the room of their dreams.
And we'll deliver it the next shields? Day.
Catalog size, next day delivery. I like that.
You gotta find a better
one.
Happens
all the time. I'm at the supermarket.
You gotta get the old.
I'm at Shaw's.
What's wrong with that?
The old couple.
I was at Shaw's when I all of a sudden realized.
I bought today.
Oh, a black person.
Deliver tomorrow.
Chizzy.
Slogan Shields. Yeah, there's not a lot of black people in Manchester, New Hampshire, that's for sure.
Oh, maybe Bernie and Phil are too old to do their own commercials.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. What's going on with Bernie?
Maybe you guys
Phil?
Chase them off the air. Maybe. Oh, no. That's exactly what happened.
Goofing on them.
Shrewsbury is howling, Anthony.
I know the way you guys get.
Shrewsbury is howling. You went real local, man.
I certainly did.
This is the next generation of Bernie and Phil.
Two and a Half Men, the opening song is hilarious. It really gets me in the mood for the show.
Yeah, I love
why Bernie.
I love how they go, man, every fucking 30 seconds
God,
on the show.
I don't know that. I've never seen the opening of that show.
That's, but throughout the whole opening. But throughout the whole sitcom, every time they have some kind of punchline, they go, man.
It really is horrifying.
Wait a minute. When do they say "man" in a high voice?
They pretty much going into every commercial break, and I think in show they even do it at times when they're cutting to another scene. They go "man."
Oh, it's play. They don't say it.
Yeah,
no, but it's
man.
It's song and it's horrendous. It's I don't know.
I have
why
to hear it. I've never heard
fucking it. Fucking show. It'll drive you nuts.
Well, it's on hiatus now. I think.
Yeah, but now they're supposed to come back. Whatever.
Isn't he leaving?
Yeah. It's like an old...
I don't know. It's serious business, guys. He's leaving, but who knows? Maybe he's holding out for more money.
Yes, we're brass knuckles.
Why don't we do a little Scorch? So anything else we need to tell Colin? I think we set it up nice. He's buying his own time.
Scorch is very talented.
He's got 90 markets.
What's the name of the show?
PFG TV.
PFG TV, which is pretty fucking great.
That was when he started that. Remember last time you showed me he was at a bar?
Yeah.
Chinese restaurant.
And I think that's when PFG first got invented.
Yes.
This is like, he's hitting it like... PFG. Now, those of you that don't know PFG is kind of like Snafu, but
wonderful.
Well, he's going to introduce a new female co-host.
Oh, wow.
He's got an anchor.
An anchor?
Not like an announcer. That's
a hole?
Are these clips worth playing for Colin?
I like them.
Because Colin, you know,
if he likes
them, special guest
good.
Today. All right, let's take a listen here. Scorch and PFG TV.
K-Ray, have a seat with us for a second, man. Come on over here, hang on for a second. I'm in the back. I'm like, wait a second. That, unless Nick has got like some sort of estrogen thing, that's not Nick.
Yeah, I was considering a trip to Sweden, but...
You know what? This is K-Ray, our new female woman announcer. Give it up for K-Ray.
Hi.
8 people there.
It's good to have you. Was that fun? Did you broke your, you broke yourself in now?
Yeah.
You're officially a member.
In front of the camera.
Good for you. Welcome to the show, sister.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Now, the funny thing is, I now have, I believe, 9 people working for the show that I'm not paying. So, you know. You all know the man on the couch. Give it up for our pal, Nick Carpinelli.
This is the guy. He adds absolutely nothing.
He is a zilch. You can't. A zero.
You can't add less than this guy.
No, he actually removes things.
Oh. What's up? I got an email that I was going to mention next week when we start our viewer email segment. I got an email from somebody in, which one? This one's in Bethel, Maine.
Uh-huh.
And they asked how I can get the Guy on the Couch segment to Bethel, Maine. So
it's very simple.
Just email us here at the station, no matter how you want to do it. You email Scorch or Nick, and you can say, I want to have Nick, the man on the couch, do a segment in my area, and you'll bring it up there, right?
Absolutely. I'll be happy to do anybody's segment anytime.
Can I ask a question? Why, with 90 markets, did it come from Bethel, Maine? Why didn't the email come from London or New York or San Francisco or Texas. Chicago, Texas?
Yeah, somewhere.
And for the record, there was no email from Bethel, Maine.
No?
Of course
no. What are you trying to say, Sam?
Well, I'm trying to say that when I interned for Scorch, one of my daily intern duties was to go home and write emails so that he could read on the air the next day.
This is why we do this. For some reason, Colin enjoys this.
I love Scotty.
Why do you enjoy it so much, Colin? It's the visual of Sam writing good emails at home.
No, I mean, I love the whole idea of just Sam, like, weaseling around this little snotty kid, and Scorch thinks he's teaching him the ropes. Yeah. And Sam is just sitting there secretly despising him and planning his subterfuge.
Scorch would always encourage me to pick.
Are you trying to say that Sam should have kept a few secrets?
No. I'm just saying Scorch is sitting there like, the kid Sam. He kind of looks up to me. And just, he has this whole image in his head that's been crashed down the past few years.
He's putting knickknacks on his desk and stuff.
Yeah.
He would always encourage me to do emails from markets that we weren't in and say that they were listening online.
That's a good idea.
Like, there are people in New York like listening online.
Is that Nick sitting on the couch?
Yeah, Nick is on the couch. So,
is that his new co-host?
Oh, well. No.
Very comely. I like that jacket.
Hold on. We're going to do a bunch of things today. Matt in the Bronx, he's got something for Colin Quinn. Matt.
Hey, Colin, what's up? Listen, I don't know if you remember. I'm going back. About 10 years ago, my friend and I were in Manhattan eating dinner, and he got into a fight. He wound up getting stabbed.
Yes.
You remember that?
Yeah, the Albanian.
Yes. Well, my friend is an Irish kid. He got stabbed by two Puerto Rican kids.
Right.
The girls were outside, and my friend and me were inside taking care of Bill. Puerto Rican kids walked by and said something to the girls. Long story short, he got plugged on the side. Nothing serious. Just stabbed real quick one time on the side. And he was bullshitting with you as he was waiting for the ambulance. Do you remember that?
Yes, of course I do.
Yes. All right. Well, I just wanted to ask you if you remember that. It was turned out to be a funny story, but he didn't really get hurt bad.
Just imagine this kid. This kid had the brass balls. He got stabbed. And then when the ambulance is coming, I run out of this place. I was in this place, and I heard some commotion. And he goes, hey, Colin Quinn. He starts talking to me, waiting for the ambulance.
As he's stabbed?
He's talking to you about, he loves you on Saturday Night Live, being the lion. And I'm sitting there with my friend. I'm like, you got this stabbed, buddy. He's like, no, I'm all right.
It's unbelievable, yeah.
I'm all right. Yeah.
All right. Well, be good.
All right, Matt.
Thank you. I remember that.
Yeah. You're going to be okay.
It was on West 80, it was on 85th Street or something.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right there, a lot of blood?
He got stabbed, and it wasn't the white guys from Sloan and Shields that stabbed
him.
No. Well.
Wow.
Anthony, Chris in Boston. Hey, Phil has MS from Bernie and Phil.
Oh, no.
Shakes worse than Michael J. Fox.
Oh.
That's why he's not doing the commercials. The commercials are done by the fat daughter and two fat sons, and one looks like Al from Happy Days.
Oh.
And I hear that sales have plummeted since Bernie and Phil have not done their own commercials. Yeah. So there's an update on our old friends, Bernie and Phil.
Oh, boy.
Tragedy.
We used to make fun of those two when we were up in Boston relentlessly.
Holy shit.
All right, well, Scorch, PFG
tragedy
TV.
Tragedy strikes Lowell.
Yeah. Or wherever. Weird news. Time for Scorch's weird news.
I remember this.
Weird news.
And before we do anything else, I say that it is time for us to get into our weird news.
Some are odd and some deranged, stories that are very strange. Weird news.
Wow. How do you stop your mom from driving drunk, you may ask yourself? You could A, call the police, B, take away her keys, or C, stab her. I hate to laugh at that, but see, just stabbing me.
Come to the audience.
Exactly.
Everybody hated to laugh at that. It was terrible.
You're saying they didn't really laugh at that?
It got an awkward titter from like two people. Got nothing.
Just stabbing me. Kind of funny, you know. Winnipeg, Manitoba, 14-year-old boy in jail now for stabbing his mom after a fight broke out due to her desire to drive drunk. He did take her keys, but after that, she stole his favorite jacket, ran out of the house with it. The boy got pissed off, whipped a knife at the mom, stabbed her through her chest. Okay? Mom is in the hospital in serious condition. The boy is in jail. The good news is mom did not drive drunk that day. So, yeah, see, so it all worked out. You know what I mean?
He finishes a lot of his material with, you know what I mean.
That's
not good, right, Colin?
Wow.
No. The you know what I mean is never
being
good.
The veteran you are, you don't end your stuff with, you know what I mean, do you?
You guys know what I'm talking about. No, a lot of comedians do that. This guy, whenever they bomb, this guy knows what I'm talking about.
You know what I'm talking about?
Look, that one guy in the audience.
Yeah, this guy knows what I'm talking about. And one guy's looking back, and I'm like, no.
No, I'm with the rest of these guys.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. I have no idea what you're talking about.
I always, when someone doesn't laugh at a joke, I'll go, hey, you guys might want to look over your head. Something just flew over there.
You're right, Chip.
Should we continue with Scorch?
Things to a grinding halt.
Idiotic smile.
Yeah, he does. But he's so happy with himself.
William Stevenson, it was so funny last night. He was really, literally revulsed. He was like, he was moving back, like, he's getting like violently. I want
revulsed is not a word.
What's something?
Oh, so what? Nobody cares.
Everyone cares.
So what? Nobody cares.
It's repulsed.
Revulsed is not a word.
It's not. I'm trying to help you.
Well, revulsion's a word.
Revolting. It is, yes.
Repulsive.
Because I say something's not a word doesn't mean you should list things that are.
You know what? Look it up. I say it is a word.
Yeah?
I'm sick and tired of this nonsense.
Okay. Scorch does a story that could only happen in America.
Only in America.
All right, let's find out.
Scotty, Pennsylvania. State troopers stopped to check on a man that was in the middle of the street on his knees. They suspected that 55-year-old Donald Wolf may just be drunk. Why would they assume that, you may ask yourself?
No.
Because he was on the ground giving mouth-to-mouth to a dead opossum. And these are all 100% true stories only in America.
only in America. Only in America.
Oh, my God, what's this word I'm looking? Revulsed.
Did you
experience revulsion? All right, I stand corrected.
Wow.
I stand corrected. But
how
about I stand corrected and I'm an ass?
I won't say I'm an ass only because once I said it, you lost all faith in the fact that it was a word. You weren't sure either. If you would have told me to go fuck myself, I would say I'm an ass. But you were in a fucking a shame sweat,
he's
too.
Got a little point there, Colin.
Yeah, mildly, but ultimately the big picture, the unjustified.
I was incorrect. Yes.
I got there from an ugly road, but still, the final verdict. I don't want you to try. You're trying to blind people with the.
It was incorrect.
Sorry. Incorrect is not a word. Wrong and pompously sitting there. Revulsed is not a word.
What up? Why don't you guys just send me to jail for 10 years or something?
Now that was a good one, Chip. I gotta admit. Some people don't know how to get out of it, but Chip does.
Chip is great.
You guys.
Whitley does have a Keith. Keith's not gonna like. Black people don't like conceptual stuff like that. So when Keith comes in, he's gonna be like, "Wow, what's he doing that for?"
I don't get it.
They don't like that kind of ironic white shit that we have.
Ironic.
I hope he shows up. We'll see.
What time is it supposed to be here? 8:30?
Yeah, 15-20 minutes. So, Scorch has a clever Tiger Woods joke.
I couldn't get a spot.
And then just turns around and goes back to Philly because he can't find street parking.
Woodbridge. Street parking midtown at 8:30 on a Thursday.
That would be the reason he would just turn around and say, fuck it.
Right. Oh, fuck, man.
Right. He wouldn't think ahead that he would be able to find a spot.
Right.
What a dope.
Finally, this is great. A company called Pipe Dream Products coming out with a Tiger Woods sex toy line.
Oh, boy.
It had to happen. You knew it had to happen. The Tiger Woods blow-up doll. And believe it or not, there's one of his ex-mistresses that is arguing this point because she's going to take it to court. They have this thing called mistress golf balls with faces of his mistresses on all the balls. And, you know, you got to think that is not the very first time that Tiger's mistresses have been that close to his balls. And there you go. There you go. That is today's installment of
I wish the people that had come up with that idea thought of that. No.
How did he fucking mumble and trip?
He really did.
Through that basic punchline.
Horribly.
And meanwhile, it's like the whole joke of the stupid product, and this idiot thinks.
Something that this came up with.
He's like, hey, guys, I'm just put a connection together.
We'll be the first time in kind of near balls.
He's got a new angle on it. And Colin, you think that Scorch thought Sam looked up to him, huh?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's secretly.
You must have sat there at the end of the day. Sam, the way you were, like, he's teaching the kid. And there's that treacherous Sam sitting there.
Treacherous.
Yeah. Listening to him with just that teenage contempt away. All like 19, just that sneer on his face. And
looking at Scorch. Him just,
And then the man on the couch, Nick, probably was like, you know, Scorch, I don't trust that kid. Nah, he's all right.
Nick didn't trust her.
I didn't know Nick. Nick is a Manch Vegas guy. I was there for the Syracuse years.
Yeah, they call Manch Vegas now, Colin.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're doing
They did that in the other thing, I know.
Oh, you remember that? Okay.
Manch Vegas.
I can't forget it.
Now, what's this about? He's got this TV show, and he realizes that he has a lot of time left.
Yeah, like he's done some segments, and you could tell, like he doesn't say it, but it's obvious that he realizes I have
this many minutes to fill, and they're not filled, and I'm drastically running out of stuff.
Oh, shit.
So he just starts talking about different ways you can get on the show.
All right, let's take a listen. It's syndicated to 90 cities.
And London.
And just making it up as he goes along on live TV.
I want to talk a little bit about how to get your stuff on to Scorch's PFG TV. The show itself, we're very proud to say, it started off as an internet-only show. It went on to a public access show. Now we're on network TV. And to see...
public access is not a step up from internet.
Network TV.
Yeah.
The My Network.
What? Sandra Bullock's baby looks like Bobby Kelly.
little black baby for Sandra Bullock.
You know, Dad.
Bobby Kelly with a more of a tan.
End of the day, Dad.
You know what? I bet you all them girls got to put their face by Tiger's putter.
Oh, Chip.
Hey, look, Anthony made the paper.
Colin and his visual humor.
Jesse's
highlights.
It's terrific.
Yeah, I'm using props today.
Yeah, Jesse.
It says show, now we're on network TV, and it seems like it just keeps growing. Now, the show cannot be a show without talented people, and I'm not talking about, you know, the staff again.
You said a mouthful there, Scorch.
Let's
start with the host.
He's lying.
I mean, he's like Chip. He reminds me of Chip.
Yeah, yeah.
Why, guy must be pretty handsome then, my call.
Oh, Chip.
Chip.
Now, do you think Scorch believes all this stuff, Colin? Do you think he believes he's a big, huge sensation now on
network
TV?
I think he believes in, he's one of those guys who believes in the positivity and, you know, like, just keep going out there and saying it, you know?
Yeah.
His voice I think he's the kind of guy that he only needs one.
So you're saying he's aware. I don't think he's aware.
No, he's not aware of how terrible he is.
It's amazing it's growing.
He needs one dullard to come up to him in a deli once a week and go, hey, man, I like your show. And go, yeah, I really am getting through to people.
How talented people, and I'm not talking about, you know, the staff on the show, because we're probably the least talented television staff you'll ever come across.
In history.
Yeah. But what I'm talking about is musical talent, and above and beyond musical talent, because honest to God, musical talent is easier to come by than other kinds of talent. It's not just music and comedy. I'm looking for, I don't want to say, you know, stupid human tricks, because that's already been done.
Really?
And the show is, even though we're similar, we're nothing like any of the other shows.
Even though we're similar, we're nothing like any of the other shows. But doesn't similarity say that you
yes,
are
exactly.
Like
my favorite part of that clip is he said nothing like any of the other shows, which means what he's thinking in his head is, I'm not going to mention Letterman or Leno. Because I'm not going to actually mention their names. They're the competition.
They're the competition, yes. Right.
Why would he give them publicity? The competition.
Anyone else notice he's doing an infomercial within his infomercial?
But just imagine this 19-year-old snotty kid from Syracuse University.
Oh, yeah.
Coming up there with that look. He can barely hide his contempt here. Can you imagine when he works for Scorch?
Why don't you sit down, Seb? Let me tell you a little something about my days at AAF Radio. And you can pick up a thing or two.
Well, tell Colin how, you know. There's a give and take thing with the Opie and Anthony show.
That was back when he used to tell me that him and Opie and Anthony used to just kind of, and still do, exchange ideas back and forth. He'd come up with bits, they'd take them.
Right.
They come up with bits, he takes them. You know, either way, like Wheel of Meat. You guys took that from him, right?
We mocked Wheel of Meat.
Oh.
We actually do it.
Douche or dressing.
We mocked that, too.
I mean, but you guys really believe that, like, deep in his damaged soul, he doesn't realize, oh, my God. What have I done?
What have I done?
You really think he just goes on blissfully unaware?
I think so.
Yeah.
I think that's what gets him through the day.
Well, he lies to
himself. Not being aware.
All day long.
Yeah.
And so it's like one of those things.
Tell Colin some of the lies from the past.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, he went on his TV show and said that he was in 90 cities in London. Like he said
well,
on one of his
probably
episodes.
Technically in London.
Yeah, there was a London, New Hampshire, I think. Londonderry, New Hampshire. There really is. Londonderry, New Hampshire.
New London.
Yeah. London, Connecticut.
He meant the local London.
The entire
London,
time,
Ontario.
Yeah.
The entire time I was
Maine
interning with him, he said that he was going to XM within the next 3 months, and it would just keep extending. Like in August, he said he'd be there in November.
Yeah.
Well, and in November, he said he'd be there by March.
But in fairness to him, I've been expecting this one pilot I wrote like 6 years ago. I keep thinking it's going to happen. Yeah. And that was about 5 years.
Someone's going to jump on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. But he said he'd had conversations. They'd offered him contracts.
Yeah, there were contracts involved.
Right.
So...
He is deluded.
But if you can do things like, I don't know, if you can turn your eyelids inside out. Do you remember how when you were a kid you used to turn your eyelids inside out?
Yes.
Wow. And
did he just say no human fucking tricks?
Yeah, well, he's looking for that.
Well, they're similar, but they're different.
How is that different than everything we've seen on TV?
He's saying musical talent is easy to come by, but when you can find somebody who's talented enough to turn their eyelids inside out, you have something for TV.
Didn't we all do that one when we were 10 years old?
For every 10 Mozarts, there's one guy that can make his ears wiggle.
My bus driver used to do that. We call him Eddie Spaghetti with the meatball eyes because he would flip his eyelids up.
Oh, my God. Like I know this is going to be a molestation story at the end of this. Flip his eyeballs up while he was, like, fingering Anthony in the back of that bus. He's like, I drop you off last.
Yeah.
Shirley gets dropped off last.
This isn't the way home.
I don't Shirley, Mr. Eddie Spaghetti.
Yeah. Eddie Spaghetti, this isn't the way home.
Eddie Spaghetti, my hiney's not ready.
Hey, kid, you ever been to Holtzville?
I like pointing out what Colin enjoys, and he loves that Long Island thing.
I love it.
Colin loves talking about Long Island town, the characters of Long Island.
I love Long Island town.
Long Island's fantastic.
I love when you go local with Long Island.
I love it.
I hope the rest of the country could appreciate your love for Long Island.
Well, it's that Suffolk County dirtbag thing that makes me love it more than
anything. Ronkonkoma.
Bayshore.
I told you, his stupid biker brother beat up my cousin.
You never got over that, did you?
My cousin never did.
You never got over it.
You held him down and punched him right in his face. Tim Gage.
From what I hear, Tim was giving Joe some shit at the time. So, had to punch him in the face. I don't know.
Tim lives in Massac. In the past 5 years, there's been like 8 murders in like just the corner where he lives.
That's the Mastic bit we do.
Mastic is a horrible
Mastic bit, right? Okay.
Mastic's a horrible place.
Because they try to fire a DJ for making fun of Mastic having, I don't know, trailer parks or something or trailer homes. And so we said, fuck that. We're now going to point out every ugly thing about Mastic.
Mastic moments. Whenever there's a crime.
Mastic moments. Whenever there's a
kid touching a murder.
There's always something going on in Mastic. I got to admire it in a way.
It is a weird fucking place.
Divorce with kids.
Oh, these kids are
Side outer. And that used to just make me so disgusted, you know what I mean? Or if you can arm fart music, I don't care, you know what I mean? Anything like that.
Oh, I'd like to kill a guy that applauded and laughed at that.
You can eat glass. You can swallow glass. You can swallow swords.
Well, eating glass is kind
of
cool.
You can swallow any number of things on the show. We'll let you do that here at Sports.
Oh, wait a minute, Scorch. Don't go there. Do not go there.
We will do things like puppet shows. You know, if you run a puppet show you'd like to show us, we'll do that. Love animal things.
No, he doesn't.
But he said no stupid like animal tricks,
right?
And stupid human tricks. Yeah. But he said
animal things.
Not tricks. He is then soliciting for everything he said he didn't want to do.
He wants puppet shows and animal things.
It's PFG.
For a show in 90 cities in London, he wants puppet shows.
Does he get anybody to do anything ever?
Show. If you make shadow puppets, if you make shadow little figures on a wall, so bring your own flashlight. We're on a budget.
I hope Misha Barton does her little puppet show from Sixth Sense.
And then someone pours some cleaner into fucking Scorch's soup. It's great, Jimmy.
Yeah, he only ever has on local comedians, and he had Gary Hoey on.
Oh, really?
Gary Hoey. Ho, ho, ho.
Well, if you work in Manchester, you might as well go on. It makes sense.
How long can you hold a handstand? Just do it. We'll watch for as long as it takes.
If you can make your finger float in the air.
You can do. If you want to play I Got Your Nose. You're a child. We don't care anything.
Holy shit. Fucking Scorch is digging deep here.
Yeah.
Oh, poor bastard.
That poor wretched bastard.
He's a good guy, though.
Does Chip have something to say?
Yes, maybe you could come out and juggle or something, you know.
He really is a fucking emergency brake.
It is.
We're all flying through the windshield right now.
Greasy, sweaty fucking hand on a rusted fucking brake handle on a train.
Hope the airbags work on. Jesus.
It's that clammy fucking hand of a man that has whacked off too much in his life, lives with his mother miserable. his father died. He still thinks his father's on the road and his mother's. It's like, well, my father was on the road. His father's been on the road since he was seven. That's helped traumatize him. He's been bullied and beaten his entire life. But as I was saying last night, we were discussing Chip at the table while Chip was there. Oh. I'm saying you can't feel sorry for him because you know he would have been a Nazi in Nazi Germany and would have killed on order. Bosnia, Rwanda, he would have been a soldier and done horrendous genocidal acts, too. So
is it Jew in the attic or something? Like just ratting fucking Jews out everywhere?
Is it Jew in the attic or something?
Or something.
I wouldn't be a good Nazi because I got glasses. I can see all the stuff.
Fucking Chip.
I'll say one thing with Chip. I never even thought Nazi.
I know. Sometimes Chip hits
Sometimes Chip hits it out of the park.
Yeah. Bunts it down the third baseline. First easy out.
Sometimes Chip gets hit in the fucking septum with a pitch when the bases are loaded.
PFG TV with Scorch. Now he advertises for audience members.
Oh, great.
Yeah, if you want to come check out the show. He just advertised for talent for the show. Now he needs an audience as well.
As far as coming to the show, we tape every Tuesday night. That is when we actually tape the show. Tuesday nights, the doors open at 7 o'clock. For the next, I'm going to say for the next 5 weeks, just as a welcome to the show type of thing, for the next 5 weeks, if you want to come into the show, your tickets are absolutely free. Yes, sir.
Wait a minute.
Wait, huh?
People are paying to see this?
No, this is one of Scorch's lies. It's not for the next 5 weeks. It's forever because last week on PFG TV, he also said for the next 5 weeks, he's lying.
Because
to him, he's like, this is going to be great. This is a good marketing scheme. People are going to sit at home saying, I got to act now. I got to get down there.
Before I have to pay.
Right.
Do you think people are acting now?
Eight of them.
I think what they should do is you should trace all the places he's worked and see how many, like, sexual assaults in the area. Because I got a feeling there's more to Scorch than meets the eye now.
I'm kind of disappointed in Sam that he's going after this guy. This guy taught you a lot.
This
in radio.
Guy is his, he said, that's what it always gets, you know, the student. Right.
What are you doing?
I'm just trying to show you guys. Look, I'm sitting here trying to get PFG TV to the next level.
He taught you a lot of secrets
exactly.
Of radio.
What are you going to turn on these guys next?
Right. Yeah, really.
I'm trying to bring
Scorch is nothing but
PFG TV to a bigger audience, that's all.
So you're saying you don't have to pay the
Because Sam Never. Was so Send young and innocent that can you imagine when he was like a kid when he was like 19 on that show?
Yeah, he didn't have the afro or nothing.
Scorch was like, oh, this kid. He's like, you know, he's a little nerdy kid. He just dismissed you kind of, but he was like,
I'll take him under my wing.
Yeah.
I'll teach him the ropes.
Yeah, Scorch never even think. He just thinks in like the most primal terms, like maybe this kid's family's got money. I can get somebody.
That's it's not even sincere.
Right.
There's an ulterior motive there.
Well, let's listen about the audience. You can go for free.
Are absolutely free. Yes, sir. You know what I mean? So we tape Tuesday nights, and of course we tape at the MCAM Television Studio, which is a really cool studio. It's high-def studio. We have a live studio, audience. And basically, you come in, we feed you Papagino's pizza, so you eat some free food. Many times, people sneak in brown bags. I don't know what's in them. I don't ask. You can do what you want with those. That's cool. But it's fun to watch a show being made. And then when you go watch the show on TV itself, you're like, oh my God, is that really how it looks?
What show are you watching being made, by the way?
The studio is HD.
Not a show.
It's HD.
The studio is HD.
The cameras aren't, but the studio is.
Who the fuck cares when they're in a studio audience if it's an HD camera filming it?
Yeah.
No one has ever wondered
Who cares?
If this was an HD shoot.
Well, this is what you guys are confused about.
Yeah.
He made that up, too.
Oh, it's not
that's HD. Just a Scorch thing that he would say. He just because he sees HD around.
It's just a term.
Small little camcorder.
I mean, it's just a public access channel. It's a hip tech term, so he just throws it out there.
That's why he said the studio. It's HD.
It's HD.
It doesn't make any sense.
The studio itself is HD and 3D.
Right.
Because if you walk into it, it's 3D.
It's like you're
and
there.
And it's HD because everything is very high definition because you're seeing it with your eyes.
I'd like to write like one of those high dramas where, you know, Scorch, I mean, where Sam goes to work for Scorch and ends up like fucking Scorch's girlfriend and living in Scorch's house. And at the end, it's just this total betrayal, you know.
That would be great.
I
trust in you.
All my secrets. Down.
It's true. He has that like Japanese like fucking Kurosawa voice. I trust in you.
I let you into the fold.
Yeah.
And you betrayed me.
And Sam can play Sam. One of you guys can play Scorch. Can't we do like a film or something? It's time to do a real serious.
Oh, that would be
get
great.
Scorch to play Scorch.
Scorch story.
Yeah,
he wouldn't
what the
fuck's
know. He doing?
Yeah, he wouldn't know. He's doing a show. He's got a tape every Tuesday.
Let's go to Neil in the rapture. Neil. Neil.
Guys.
He's a mess.
Guys, I'm willing to do the movie. Tuesday's out. One condition. Tuesday's out.
I still got to film my TV show. Neil.
Yes.
What do you got, buddy? Let's go.
Hey. I live here in New Hampshire, and the other day I happened to be in a friend's car, a piece of shit car that didn't have XM. And lo and behold, Sports has got a go-to-hell line. Okay. It's a complete rip-off of your FU line.
Well, he wouldn't say that, though. He's just...
ideas.
Yeah, we're trading ideas. Yeah, don't you know that?
Well, the thing about the go-to-hell line is it was actually before... You guys actually took the FU line.
Is that what he's saying?
Oh, yes!
Is that what he's saying?
Go-to-hell line. No, Sam's saying that really happened.
Yeah, Sam.
You guys did steal off
we
Scorch.
We stole it from Scorch.
Did we steal it from Scorch?
I always felt that way.
See, he's a fucking asshole.
Did he really have it first? These guys did steal it.
I mean, you guys.
He has
Colin, he's listening to you. He's listening to you, see?
He took.
He's defending his mentor.
You guys took Fields for Meals from him, so.
Oh, we did?
That's what he told me. But the first time I met him.
That was our AAF idea.
That was my idea.
You mean his AAF idea?
He's saying he came up with that?
He told me that the first day I met him.
Well, there you go then.
I mean, he's not going to lie the first day.
Scorch starts rock and rolled. Is that what it is?
You know how Scorch likes to do bits where he shows people pictures every single time we've played this? He has
to. Yeah.
Rock and rolled.
Yeah.
Is where you show a picture of a rock and roll star when they were young, and then next to them. Now, what they look like that they're old.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah. Holy shit. Yes.
What happens? What's that mean? While he's rocking this bit, the audience rolls out?
This is a segment we call Rock and Roll.
I hope Zeppelin.
I hope soon.
How great would that be?
Yeah,
takes the little he has.
Look, people, I can't afford the Papagino's pizza anymore. I'm in heavy litigation with Led Zeppelin.
How great would that be?
So, no Papagino's pizza. And I'm going to have to start charging tickets even though the 5 weeks hasn't expired.
Yeah.
Oh, how great would that be?
Wait, Chip wants to say something.
This guy be a Led Zeppelin Susan. They'll be on a stairway up to the courthouse.
Oh, it almost takes your breath away.
It does. Oh, man.
God bless Colin Quinn.
Courthouse.
God bless him. You figured out a way to at least deal with him.
Oh,
I hope Zeppelin makes an example of squashing. He's homeless for the years. They're like, you know, we got to start somewhere. We got to make an example.
But then they listen to his lies. He says it's in 90 cities.
Right.
No, yeah, it's not 90 cities.
Oh, fuck. I made that up. Please.
What happened?
All right. This is a segment we call Rock and Roll. Nice, thank you. You want to see how some of these people age? Let's go on. I think we start off, if I'm not mistaken, with Henry Rollins, which, Nick, if you can go to his armpits, one thing is to pose for your picture, but why the hell do you pose for a picture with sweaty armpits like that?
It looks like it's a cameo. It doesn't really look like he was posing. It looked like somebody said, hey, dude. And he looked.
Do you think those are
who makes a cameo in a photo?
Cameo.
See, but explain. That's the greatness of Nick you just heard, Colin.
Yeah.
Well, when
isn't that terrific? He misuses the word cameo.
Right.
Not only did he misuse the word cameo, but Scorch was setting up for like a joke that he was going to start going with, and Nick said, "No, that's not accurate. He wasn't posing. It doesn't apply to this."
Oh.
So now Scorch's joke isn't going to make sense.
He really does pull the rug out from Scorch every
time. What did he mean to say instead of cameo, though? He was trying to say like a candid shot.
Candid shot. Yes. Cameo.
Okay, it's like a cameo.
Word up.
Oh, God.
It looked like somebody said, hey, dude, and he looked.
Do you think those are painted on to make him look like a tough guy?
What, the tattoos?
Yeah, no, the sweat things on his
sleeves.
No,
no, no.
They're not even on the same
The chemistry.
Not even on the same
that is
page.
Ammonia and bleach. That's their chemistry. Breathe deep, audience.
They're not even on the same page with a hack joke.
It looks like two different shows were spliced together.
How do you fuck that up?
The couch. Jesus.
The only way that would have worked is if you go, no, what, the tattoos? No, not the fucking tattoos, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Dope.
Right. Yeah, you should have laid into them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I got to keep it clean for the children. We're in 90 cities.
Next time.
What, the tattoos? Yeah, no, the sweat things on his.
I think that's just.
Henry Rollins, who I will go on the record. Henry, you'll never be on the show because you're one of the biggest pricks I've ever seen in my life. There you go.
Whoa.
I said it, yes, I did.
Whoa, he said it.
I said
why
it, yes,
is
I did.
What's his reason for this? I want to hear this now.
Yeah, but you know what? Like, Henry Rollins is like, oh, fuck. Yeah. I'm not going to be on PFC TV now.
Damn. Here's what happened. He's asked Henry Rollins 30 times and never heard back.
Yes. And there's a restraining order. Yeah. Leave me alone.
Henry Rollins is upstairs.
I like the fact that he goes, he's one of the biggest pricks I've ever seen in my life, too.
Holy, yeah. Holy shit, a letter from Led Zeppelin. Wait a minute, maybe they want to do the show. If you open that up, take a look. What's a cease and desist? What does that mean? I don't understand.
Although I will say, Scorch advertised that within the coming weeks, maybe months, Bob Saget would be doing comedy on his show.
Wow.
Oh, really? Scorch has said that Bob Saget is going to do stand-up comedy.
How's he
going to
get out of that lie, you think?
He's going to play old clips.
I bet it's true. What if he's doing... He might be doing a show in Manchester. He's going to sell tickets.
I heard there's a little TV show that would have Monty. Has no idea. Shot in a garage.
It's HD.
It's a HD garage.
Yeah. Yes.
HD. Yes.
Well, let's continue with Rock and Old or Rolled.
Rock and Rolled.
Whatever. Rolled.
Yeah.
Up next, we've got one of our two Rolling Stones guys.
Oh, God.
I remember once on public TV in Boston, I think it was all around, there used to be a show called Zoom.
Yeah.
A little kid's show. And one time on Zoom, they did a story about this dried applehead doll lady.
Yes. So
Mick Jagger looks just like a dried applehead doll.
Oh, my God. Like the thing on Zoom 31 years ago.
I'm a little worried that the people in London won't get the Zoom reference.
But right, it's the way he gets to it. Instead of going, he looks like a dried apple head like you saw on Zoom.
Yeah.
He goes, hey, there was a show called Zoom. I think it was on different time in mountain time.
Right, Zoom, ZOOM, box 350, Boston, Mass. 02134.
Yeah.
Wow, what a good memory.
Jesus, Anthony.
Oh, I just remember this thing.
It's not making us look
I don't know
stupid.
How.
God, this guy's got a memory. Looks like a bunch of photographs were just pulled up.
I hate it.
That wasn't really a slam, though, Chip. That was more like a compliment.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying this guy remembers everything. Boy, you gotta get up pretty early and pull one by this character.
You seem to admire Anthony, Chip.
I do. I think he's got some good stuff.
Smart. Chip.
Yeah.
I don't think you guys. I don't think you guys should be very flattered that Chip happens to be a rabid O&A fan.
I know
he's quite the listener. He's very loyal listener to the show.
Very loyal.
Chip, you
yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, sorry.
No, go. All right.
No, I want to hear about Henry Rollins.
All right, let's go. Mick Jagger now. Remember that fucking applehead.
Oh, head's all, Danny. Look at that.
He does.
He'd also make a great Pez dispenser.
That's rough, man.
He looks hell, but
wow,
dude. He's
bombing. Even Nick goes, that's rough, man.
That's rough, man.
That was a little over the line now.
That's
he made a good Pez dispenser.
He looks hell, but
that's rough.
You know what? He has so much money, he could probably make himself look back to the other one, don't you think? But
he could buy a new one.
At least he's not getting beat up by his girlfriend like Ronnie Wood is.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you, DJ Ferris.
These guys are like Chip Chipperson. The same jokes.
At least he's not getting beat up by his girlfriend or something.
I was thinking that. I was going to say, at least his girlfriend's not, you know, beating the Rolling Stones out of him.
You belong on Scorch, Chip.
I would love to.
Norton should go undercover as Chip under Scorch's show.
Yeah. That guy Nick is good. Quick. Top dresser.
Well, Scorch finishes the bit with this.
And finally, this one here. Okay, here's what Miley Cyrus is going to grow up to look like. She's all hot now. She thinks she's all great. Yeah, I'm all cool. And I'll put tattoos on my private areas. And I'll wear these little skimpy panties on stage. But you know what,
Jesus,
Miley?
Calm down.
This is what you're going to grow up into, baby. And that is what is called rock and roll.
Wait a minute.
when he goes, and this is what you're going to grow up to be, shouldn't there have been a laugh or a reaction there?
It's probably a picture of Billy Ray or something. You're right.
Yeah, yeah. There was nothing.
There was nothing but like, oh, they were like, waiting to see where it was going, and Scorch is playing the music. The Zeppelin's out.
He's
going to Nick like this. Come on.
Blatant licensing problem.
So we got to
go into my licensing issue and play the Zeppelin.
We should report him.
I like the fact that
we should report him to Atlantic Records.
We should report him. We should.
But at least you picked like a distinctive Zeppelin song, not like a hack.
Well, it goes with the band. Rock and roll.
Yeah, rock and roll. Great.
Come on, he's thinking.
Oh, is he?
We're almost done. Scorch and Nick attempt to tell a joke together while introing some music act.
But could you play? Could you just play back again when he said Pez dispenser?
I just wanted to see like that. You enjoyed that, right?
That bomb.
And Nick goes, "That's rough.
That's rough. Monumental."
Nick never backs him up.
No,
never.
No.
And he's not even doing it to spite him. He just doesn't have the humor in him at all to say that this would be the opportunity for me to help him out.
Right.
Nick is a creative and energy vacuum.
You think, Jimmy?
Yeah. Sucks everything out.
We've been listening to a lot of PFG audio. Not one thing has interest us.
No.
That Nick has said.
No, nothing. He's terrible.
Not a wanna. All right, here.
Very rarely do I get like, I don't want to say giddy, but you know what I mean? That's probably a good kind of word to put. But very rarely do I get giddy over guests.
Well, considering the things you were doing in the cars to their music.
Yeah, do you know what I mean? I can probably be more giddy now because I don't think I was doing anything then.
I don't think you do anything now.
That's what I mean. So, it is our extreme pleasure to introduce to you.
What's going on?
It just makes you angry.
He was trying to say that he's having sex to the music in the cars, but then Nick took it and somehow twisted it to say you weren't doing anything now because you're older, and then and somehow then, Scott said you weren't doing. I wasn't doing anything then. I'm telling you, there's no logical sequence. We should hear that again.
They haven't even set up that it's a band.
I gotta hear this
again. Let's try to figure out what they're
figure out what at least the fuck's
what they want.
Let's play a game called "What the fuck is Scorch talking about?"
Yeah.
Very rarely do I get like, I don't want to say giddy. But you know what I mean? That's probably a good kind of word to put. But very rarely do I get giddy over guests.
Well, considering the things you were doing in the cars to their music.
Yeah, do you know what I mean? I can probably be more giddy now because I don't think I was doing anything then.
I don't think you do anything now.
That's what I mean. So it is our
that's
extreme.
Not what you meant.
No.
And look what at you me, meant, look which at is you. The opposite. No. What the first guy was saying, Nick was saying, when you were younger, you'd be fooling around in the cars to them. Then Nick was like, I get more action, so probably more than I did then. I wasn't getting any. And then Nick goes, I don't think you're doing anything now, like being normal, like you're old. And he goes, that's what I meant, even though he meant the exact opposite. Nick actually made sense then. He was trying to say when you were young, you were getting laid in the cars, now you're old.
Sure. Right.
But somehow Scorch was trying to say the opposite, but then claimed that he meant what Nick said. That's what happened.
It is our extreme pleasure to introduce to you the MyTV audience and the PFG TV audience, Charlie Farron and John Butcher. This is Farron Butcher. Hey.
Who?
Charlie Farron and John Butcher, Farron Butcher Inc.
There's probably some local band from New Hampshire.
They're old. I don't know. He talked to them like they've been in music for quite some time and made quite an impact. So I assume they had, and I'd missed it.
They're probably local good band musicians from around the area.
Oh, I'm sure they're really good.
They're good in that zip code. That's about it. Holy shit. This is exhausting, but it is labeled greatest clip ever.
This is
spiritually debilitating.
This is next clip.
Hold on a minute. We got Keith Robinson. Hey, Keith. Keith Robinson, everyone. You got Jim Norton in the studio and Colin Quinn. What's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, man? What's happening? Colin, you are in every cop movie. Colin, what you called as the neighborhood informant. He snitched on me. Oh, Keith won't make it. I seen him last night.
And where are you?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Where are you?
How could you make up something for your friend, you snitch?
Where are you?
He probably had family troubles. I'm in stupid traffic with my Easy Pass that doesn't work anywhere.
Wait a minute. You're supposed to be at 8 o'clock. We said 8 o'clock last night.
8:30.
It's 8:38, and you're still stuck in Easy Pass.
But Easy Pass is the worst. It has no effect on the Lincoln Tunnel. None.
What?
Works when I use it.
Yeah, me too.
It works. My Easy Pass is racist.
Well, you're not supposed to, for an 8:30 appearance, you're not supposed to leave to hit tunnel traffic at 8 o'clock from Woodbridge.
I think he's lying. He's nowhere near the English. He's in his house.
I'm not in my house.
Beep your horn.
You can hear traffic. I'm going to show you traffic.
Beep the horn.
And it's this big trucker right in front of me that I'm peeping.
How funny would that be? The guy just snatched him out.
Yeah.
Well, payback for Reginald Denny.
How long till you're here?
I don't even know. I'll probably just be set in traffic and have breakfast in the city when I finally get there about 10. All it's right. Awful.
That's Keith's lonely way of saying, guys, would you go to have breakfast with me at 10?
I do not like Colin being an informant.
Yeah, he did. He's a
neighborhood snitch.
I rolled right over on you.
Yeah.
Well, because we're standing outside at 11 o'clock. You just got in. You're all dolled up. And you're like, yeah, I don't know. And you go, where is it again? And you talk to me. I just don't like
there being. There you go. Every bit of information you give, Colin, I said that to you.
Right.
Right.
This old man can't retain information. Here's what I know.
Here's what you ought to do. You ought to just.
The drugs and Jim Norton's with a tranny named Nancy.
No. What you ought to do is you ought to just put your siren on, tell everybody it's some kind of an emergency.
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, Chip.
Chip is really.
Fucking, I horrifying. Can't take Chip.
All right, well, we'll see when you get here.
All right.
Bye, sweetie.
All right, Keith Robinson will be here, so. But
what a nincompoop.
We were going to stop, but it says.
Oh, it's not like you're going to say something racist.
Yeah, very good, Chip.
We were going to stop with the Scorch clips, but this one says greatest clip ever. You want to explain this one, Sam?
Wow. It's my favorite clip that's ever been on television.
wow.
That's pretty a good. Bold statement. Scorch had his, you know, his big band in, and one of them had a DVD that I guess you can purchase on his website.
Okay.
And Scorch had them give him a piece of tape to play because, you know, he's one of those, it's like a talk show.
Yeah, you know, so like Letterman or Leno, you know, you got to play a clip from your project.
A clip.
Yeah, sure.
They'll go to tape. Scorch sent it to tape and sat awkwardly as nothing happened and then started talking about how he would take this out in editing. And then aired it on television. This is not a studio feed. This is what aired on the mine to 90 cities and to London.
So he covered his ass with the studio audience going, yeah, we fucked up, obviously, but I'm going to take that out in editing.
But he was too lazy to do it.
Right. There's no editing. Yeah.
He didn't edit it.
So it was really a retrospective of my career of what I've done. It was a terrific show.
Good for you. And we have a piece of this on video, right?
Yeah.
Why don't we see a piece of Charlie Farron retrospective live at the Regent Theater, and then we're going to talk about the future of...
Future.
Can we not do this yet? No? Yes, maybe? Oh, okay. Good thing we have editing, huh? Because there's slight difficulty.
Oh, my God.
Shh, everybody quiet.
Yeah, because they do that. They just shut themselves off all the time. I find it difficult to keep one on.
What the fuck?
I like the sound effect. What trick is that? Do you trigger that? Nice. Yeah.
This is abominable.
Are we good? So we can just find out. We're going to edit right into it. Okay, so just run the tape. Let's go.
That's how it ends.
All right, that's if you're one of the 90 fucking people that watch this show, that's what you would have seen on TV, right?
Yes, this. Wow. The recording I got was taped off of television. There's no secret. Somebody watched it on TV, taped it, and sent it to me.
Yeah,
that's what was on television.
Right. Edit it out.
And he just sat there rubbing his bald head and throwing his pen down as if he was frustrated.
All right, we got our final
professional.
Clip.
He doesn't like when things like that happen.
Scorch and PFG TV. We end with this one.
Welcome back. Scorch is PFG TV. How about this? So right now, Scorch's PFG TV is on My Network Television New England and about 3 million homes plus the 90 cities.
3 million homes in New England?
Homes.
Did you hear that, Colin?
Wow. Three,
that's half the audience of Celebrity Apprentice. I think Celebrity Apprentice is doing about six and a half.
3 million homes, 90 cities.
So it's
plus 90 cities.
He's trying to make New England Sports Network. 3 million
is just New England.
Right, right. He thinks like New England Sports Network.
Yeah.
That's just New England. So if he's, you think,
oh wait, he's saying yes, 3 million
plus
homes,
90 cities,
plus 90,
3 million homes on the My Network in New England, in New Hampshire, in Manch Vegas, 3 million homes.
So you figure 90 more cities. Let's just say not even a million a city.
So more people are watching PFG TV than the Super Bowl.
He's implying he has about 83 million viewers.
3 million is polluted. You're right. I take it back.
He's out of his head.
Completely out of his mind.
I'm telling you, you should check every city he's worked at.
I think that would be about 270 million viewers.
No, no, because he's saying New England. He's not saying one area.
So 3 million in New England. Yeah. So not every city's doing 3 million for him. I got you. So we're averaging it down a little bit.
Yeah, he wouldn't lie about that. I'm saying that's disrespectful.
Safe to say 10 million people?
I'll say 700,000 per city. So you figure 700,000 times 90.
That's another six.
Wow. 63 million people. 63 million.
So you're pushing fucking
66 million people.
Oh, right.
A week.
A week.
All right. Yeah. You're right.
Welcome back. Scorch is PFG TV. How about this? So right now, Scorch's PFG TV is on My Network Television New England. And about 3 million homes, plus the 90 cities around coast to coast on cable, right? So I'm working on this deal that probably by the time this show actually airs, Scorch's PFG TV is going to be on from Albany, New York to Buffalo, New York, adding another 4 million homes to the So the show is blowing up. And I want to thank everybody for making it a part of what's becoming the fastest growing entertainment television show on network TV, and I appreciate that.
What are you talking about?
Come on, he didn't just say that.
Yes, he did.
Well, you know what it is? At the beginning, he's trying to say my TV, like the channel is on.
Yeah.
But then he throws his show in, but then he starts getting really just lying. I'll lie.
The fastest growing entertainment.
And it's on network TV.
So what does that mean? Who's he beating out?
Do you want to know
who's
what,
he beating out?
Sam seems to understand him better than
Sam. Yes. Do you want to translate
what his deal is with the 4 million people from Albany to Buffalo?
What's his deal?
He is trying to convince one of the local stations in Syracuse to put him on. That's what he's talking about. That's his deal. Syracuse. Adding another 4 million homes.
And he thinks if you're on in Syracuse, you might get some of the outskirts of Buffalo listening?
He's thinking Albany to Buffalo.
Yeah.
It's just a local channel in Syracuse.
Wow.
But why would he brag about that when he's on in 90 cities?
And like, London.
If you're on in 90 cities in London, why would you care about... And why are you not on...
Yeah.
In Albany.
Places so close to you. Albany, Buffalo. Like, what are the other cities?
If you're in 90 cities, you would assume you'd be on in Albany. That's not that far away from where he's at.
By the way, he said an additional 4 million homes. Now, as we all know, a home includes families, so that's more than 4 million people.
You're right. That's probably 12 million people.
Yeah, you know what it is? It's that Sam is like Tony Montana and Scorch is like Frank Lopez.
I mean, you would think that he would already be on it in Syracuse, especially with the reputation that he developed. He told me that when he was doing afternoons in K-Rock, he had to stop going out to the mall and stuff because he'd go to the mall and he'd be on the first level. People on the second level would be leaning over the rail going, Scorch!
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he can't leave his home at this point, Colin.
Yeah, yeah. Now with the...
He really is a deluded maniac.
He is insane.
You called him a deluded maniac.
Holy shit.
I can't get enough of this guy.
I'm on my TV.
Yeah. Yeah,
and if you pitched him the movie about him being betrayed, he wouldn't do it because he would think that it's unrealistic that somebody could outsmart him.
Does he get the tapes of our show and what you're doing to him?
our fans.
He gave you your first break, basically.
Can look what you're doing. Like a 5-minute movie about Scorch with Sam playing himself and like, making like a kung fu movie. And...
it would be great. I love the little kicker where he has sex with Scorch.
Yeah.
And the loyalty part is just fantastic. Oh, the storyline is great.
I like the fact that Zeppelin's going to sue him.
Yeah, no, you put Zeppelin in the soundtrack and they really sue him. Imagine at the Tribeca Film Festival.
I gotta take this.
Tribeca Film Festival. Oh, everybody's sitting and suddenly this.
Oh.
Hope it's not the gay men's health crisis on the phone. Bad news for Gregorio. What the hell's that?
Well, when he runs out of the studio with the phone.
What does it mean?
We don't know if his wife's having a baby.
You don't know because, she could be a day late. She's actually a day late.
Wow.
So, you know, when he runs out like that with the phone, you're thinking, oh boy. This could be the big one.
That's it.
That Ricky Ricardo moment. Lucy's having a baby! He runs in there, the cigars. That's the old school way of doing it. We always talk about like how... I don't like this newfangled way people are having kids with a fucking husband in there holding the mother's hand and breathe and all that shit. He should be in the waiting room with his friends... And then the nurse comes out and says it's a boy or a girl or something. And then they light up a cigar and have a shot.
That's then he goes and
old Bray
has one last fling with the secretary. Go, now I can't see you no more, honey. I got kids now.
Now I have kids. It's not appropriate. Smash her on the ass. Take a letter.
She's heartbroken and turns into like the local harlot drinking every night. Four roses at the bar. Banging all these other guys. The late 50s.
You gotta love it. Yeah.
Oh, my God, who got eliminated from American Idol?
Siobhan.
How do you know that?
I was watching.
Why?
She was my favorite to win, too.
That show.
She looks pretty cute. She looks like one of the girls from Bananarama. Are they still popular?
Bananarama.
Yeah, she's going to have to be on a show called American Idol. Not.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you did a not.
Shep is really shameless. There's just there's a level of hostile. It's like really there's something you know underneath Chip that really is just hostile and violent. That's why I say it reminds me of like Rwandan. Like he's like your next door neighbor that'll just turn on you, just eviscerate you and rape your family. You know?
Yeah, you could tell. Like there's something about his look and his demeanor.
Yes,
that he's trying to be funny, but
there's
he's
a lot
very
of
mean.
Yeah, very mean,
angry. And yeah, he'll turn on you in a second.
I just like to make people laugh. There's nothing to it.
Yeah.
I've always been funny.
He's
my
like
whole
a
life.
Mean Rupert Pupkin.
Cracking people up all over the place.
Well, yeah.
Jealous.
Yeah.
He's like, he thinks he's making people laugh all over the place.
Yeah, yeah. I'll wait. I'm wondering if this is the moment or something.
I got a tinkle.
Are you going to tinkle?
Yeah, why don't we take a break and come back?
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, we'll take a break. Let's take a break because we got. Oh my God, we have so many commercials today. But it's not a good thing to tell the listeners because then they tune out.
Yeah, that's not very professional of you.
Great way to keep them listening.
Yeah.
You know, you just said that.
A lot of commercials.
Yes. Why don't you just tell them, hey, stick around for a few hours. We're going to have all kinds of different things like static and stuff for you.
Static.
And stuff for you.
All right. Hey, PFG TV, let's get into this. Sam.
Yeah,
get a mic and let's roll with this shit. This is for Colin Quinn. I am Colin Quinn on Twitter, by the way.
Oh,
we're talking about Twitter.
That's right. Well, you can get him a few ways now with the show.
Yeah,
also.
That's true.
Yeah, telecharge.
He's a beaten man already.
Helen Hayes. Dude.
Only took an hour.
Long story short, Colin Quinn.
Sam.
Yeah.
Scorch is back, huh?
That's right.
We never went away. We just go away because we can't take too much
too
of
much
shit.
Too much.
Right.
Yeah. Scorch is like LSD. You just don't want to do it all the time.
No.
But every once in a while, it's fun.
It's nice to revisit.
Yeah.
Because you go into a different world.
Yeah. The show's like pot. You can do it every day. It's fun.
Yeah. So for the new listeners, just summarize. What is this Scorch character all about?
Well, Scorch is a man who taught me everything I know about radio.
Yeah.
He was Syracuse's finest rock DJ. I got hooked up with an internship after interning here and going back up to Syracuse.
You did. You were a traitor. You left here just to go up to Syracuse.
Scorch stole me away.
For Scorch.
Well, we knew Scorch before you, and unfortunately for him, he was pizza and we were hamburger.
Right, and that's the programming director. Right. He said, both are great, but the station's more heading towards hamburgers than
and
pizza.
And your pizza. Because pizza's great. A lot of times I want pizza.
I got an update on that program director, by the way, about a year ago.
Dead?
He's a greeter at a supermarket.
No way.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's how bad his life got.
Using his communication skills?
Yeah, that's how bad his life got.
Yeah, it's good. Good for
he
him.
He greets people at a big-time grocery store.
The guy that
in
cut
the, Boston
the
area.
Placenta falls to the floor line out of Lightning Crashes because I think his wife
fuck, I forgot about that.
You remember that?
He was editing songs before anyone else started doing it.
Editing songs. There's a line, the placenta falls to the floor and Lightning Crashes.
Right. I forgot
and,
about that one.
Our program director, and I'm convinced, in my opinion, that his wife was
hated
so overbearing and
hated us,
hated the station, hated the rock music, hated that offended her, that he cut it out of the song. So the song started on the second verse. And we would get mocked for it. Because people would be like, BCN doesn't do it. Right. You guys are faggots. And we'd have to sit there and go, yes, we're faggots. Sorry.
Well, that is very offensive, the placenta falling.
Yeah, placenta falling to the floor is just, it conjures up an image, Colin.
Well, then don't fucking play the song.
Yeah, yeah, then just don't play the fucking thing.
PFG TV's back.
So. Right, so Scorch, after tearing it up in Syracuse, decided to go to New Hampshire and leave his co-host behind without mentioning to him until the day before. Scorch is the best because the entire time I was
fend
there.
For yourself, Scorch.
I was with him for 9 months. Not only was he fending for himself, but he was telling his co-host, Paulie, don't worry about it. I'm sending out tapes of us. They're going to pick us up somewhere. Don't worry about it.
He was telling him,
do not send your tapes out because I'm sending out tapes of both of us, while he already knew that in 2 months he was going to New Hampshire without Paulie.
He didn't want him sending his tapes out, so Paulie didn't get another gig.
Yeah.
Oh,
and there was no reason for it.
I love watching Colin as we talk about Scorch. Yeah. It's my favorite thing in the world.
You learn a lot from Scorch.
Colin can't get enough of Scorch.
You do.
And while Scorch told me that he would technically be making around the same amount of money, which, since Scorch lies constantly, is obviously less money, with the bar gigs added on to his salary, he'd be making six figures with bar gigs.
Plus, it was that classic relationship of like the older kind of pompous guy who thinks he's schooling this young kid. He doesn't see the contempt.
I know.
He
doesn't see the sarcasm that's dripping off of this kid.
He's
every
like,
time
kid,
Scorch went
learn,
to give him,
learn from me.
So words
Sam's
of wisdom.
Just noticing everything the whole time.
Oh yeah, Scorch. Wow, what a great bit of info you just gave me.
When I was
you take that with you, kid.
Writing Scorch's emails that were from listeners.
Now go get me a cup of coffee.
Pushing him around, stabbing his friend in the back, but he doesn't think he
knows. It's called paying your dues. Paying your dues, kid. I did it. Oh, really?
I had to write like 5 or 6 emails every night.
Oh. And
he'd tell me to, all of them shouldn't be from Syracuse because some of them, because they could listen to streaming. So make sure, you know, they're from New York. New York City.
They're not listening. Streaming.
He knows.
All right, well
let's,
it leads us
to
his big cable access show.
Right, he moved to New Hampshire.
He doesn't look at it as a cable access show.
No, it's on the My9 or whatever the equivalent is, the My Network.
But he pays during the paid programming portion.
Right, it's Saturday late night, and right before the show starts, it says the following show has been paid for.
Yeah.
The views expressed are not those of My Network Television.
They don't even say not necessarily.
No, so they're not.
It's just actually, they put absolutely not the opinion of this station.
Right.
We didn't even want to accept his money, but we're very poor.
But Scorch talks like My Network came and saw his public access show and says we need this for our network.
I got picked up for another season.
Right, exactly.
I was able to, finagle a few bucks.
He's be part of the Seinfeld Mafia soon.
And he spends half the show.
Yeah, sure he is.
He spends half the show just asking for sponsors.
Yeah,
which
he's
just trying to get people to give him money that he doesn't share with his staff.
He's going to fucking do a commercial for maple syrup up there? Up in the fucking
he has
boonies?
Done. Yes.
Maple syrup.
He's done stuff for...
Well, let's get right into the audio.
Yeah, let's hear some of Scorch's wonderful TV
Scorch,
show.
Scorch starts the show by fist-pumping Nick and making hilarious fisting jokes. He says nothing about pause for a cause, then goes back to fisting jokes.
Fisting. Fist me, Nick, fist me.
Oh, I love fisting you.
Why do I always
and
miss
I missed it?
Oh. You know it's going to be a fine day when you can't even fist your best friend.
Or you miss fist
him. I miss fist my best friend. That's not a good thing. Welcome, everybody, to Scorch's PFG TV. Get up.
He's the best. Welcome, everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he treats it like it's a real deal, like late night.
Like it's Letterman or something.
Like, right. Yeah, yeah. He's
he has no
clue
doing that no one gives a shit about him or his show.
He actually did once on the show say, I don't. He talked about something he saw on Leno,
but he wouldn't mention Leno's name because he said he didn't want to bring up the competition's name.
Competition!
He actually said
he sits at a card table. He sits at a folding card table. It's fucking... It's like the Little Rascals putting on a show.
It is.
It's horrible.
It's slightly worse.
Pay as you exit. That's right, Spank.
Come everybody, Scorch, it's PFG TV. Get up, yeah.
Get down.
Oh my God! What in the?
I love the smattering of applause. Oh, how many people are at this taping?
There, I mean, they can only fit like.
Is this the Chinese place still, or did he get kicked out of there?
No, now he's in a local access TV studio. But I mean, you could fit 15 people maybe in there.
All right.
But I'm telling you, this is the most popular show in Manch Vegas.
Manch Vegas.
That's what they call it.
That's a good Manch. Remember last time?
Right, Manch Vegas.
Right. Patrice is done.
Patrice is just nodded off at Scorch.
You need orange juice? You're good.
No, this ain't the same.
It's not that. You're just tired.
Just Scorch.
All right.
Sorry.
What an interesting thing, you know, for anybody wondering. Last week we didn't air because I was in my little cage for the pause for the car. So
pause
to talk about that. I am just now starting to recover.
Is that the event where we had one of our listeners throw paint on him?
Throw paint on him.
Yes. You know that one, right, Colin?
Which one?
Where he sits.
Was it paint or mustard?
It was paint. Where he sits in a dog cage. For
the whole weekend or whatever?
Yeah. To raise money for dogs.
Cause for pause.
Right, cause for pause.
And he gets in the cage, the doggy cage, and people come by, see him in the doggy cage, and give him money for the cause. And but something, does it go to the cause? Yeah. Hey, who knows? Maybe
no,
there should
it
be
doesn't.
An accounting.
Yeah.
It's going to.
So we thought it would be a good idea if our listeners threw paint on him.
So he had to listen because he couldn't get out of the cage. That's so they threw paint on him.
That's when he stopped calling the show.
That pretty much ended our relationship.
I'll never forget when I was trying to get him to come back on the air and he goes, yeah, Sammy, this is not cool. Somebody just came up and threw yellow paint on me. Scorch, I don't know what's happening. Some of our listeners get overzealous.
Yeah.
We never told them to do that. I know, Sammy, I know. The guys love me, I know.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, he has no clue. He thinks we just absolutely love him, which I guess is kind of
going to play douche addressing. Yeah, I love the guy, but, you know, I don't
What does he say? We share ideas?
Yeah, when our first was interviewing with him outside of a Bennigan's, he said that you guys share ideas. Sometimes he'll do stuff from your show. Whereas the same way you guys have done stuff from his show, Feels for Meals, and things like that.
Oh, so he took credit for Feels
How
for
is
Meals.
He taking credit for that?
That was his idea.
Get the fuck out of here.
You know, Feels for Meals, douche dressing.
They do rhyme. Feels for Meals rhymes, and Scorch loves
Scorch
to
is a
rhyme.
Big rhymer.
It's now starting to recover. I was crunched up like some. When you're a human being living in a
cold room. No, I didn't think of anything up.
That gets crunched
he
up.
He couldn't think of something that. I was crunched up like like a crunched up thing. That's Chip Chipperson.
It's not really a natural thing to do, you know, but we're going to talk about that soon. Hey, look, why is it? Mark, can you get a close up of my blood? Why is it every time that I fist you, I get bloody?
Because we're tight.
Oh, yeah. Someone likes
because my fist is tight. There you go. That's a good one.
What?
That's a good one.
His fist is tight.
But the fist isn't tight. The anus would have to be tight.
No, no, no.
The fist would have to be big. Fist. And you'd have to, I don't know. I don't even want to figure it out.
It's a
good exhausted.
One. Fist and tight is a good one.
I'm exhausted even thinking about this.
Let's go right into the next clip. He's very excited about what's coming up on PFG TV.
Oh.
Furious, who was my cage... He wasn't my cage mate, I shouldn't say.
Was he your cage master?
He was my kennel mate throughout that week. You did a good job again, though, man. Thank you much, you know. And so we're going to talk about how much I raised soon, because it was one of the best ones yet. But a couple of good things going on with the show that I want to get into quickly. For instance, we're growing by leaps and bounds. We have more cities joining the Scorch's PFG TV network. Yeah!
Come on.
Not only more cities... But more states. For instance, we are working on Florida, and we are working on Texas, and we are working on Atlanta and Georgia. Atlanta's still in Georgia, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
And some of the areas in Northern California as well. So we got a lot of things going on.
He's working on.
I know.
Please, because my ex lives there, and she might think I'm making money.
Now, is that your first or your second? Okay.
That'd be my first one.
Now, everybody on the staff can vouch that this show does not pay a dime. Which is why we're always looking for sponsors, which we'll talk about.
God, Scorch, man. Holy
well, did
shit,
you hear that? I mean, you guys make fun of him, but he's working on Atlanta.
Working on.
Florida.
Yeah.
What do you think? Scorch is the type of guy that says things like, I'm working on this, to cover up for the fact that he's completely lying that because you nothing, can't prove or disprove?
Yeah, you can't prove or disprove working huh. on.
You gotta love his enthusiasm, though. He thinks yeah. He's a, yeah.
he won't give up.
No,
he thinks he's
he won't.
A media mogul.
I was so freaked out when he kept telling me that he was having conversations with people at XM, that he was going to be joining you guys at XM.
Yeah, yeah.
He once broke down that he was talking to Kevin Straley, who was in charge then.
Wow, back in the old days.
Yeah, and that he had had a conversation with him, that they had talked about growing up in the same town, and he had all these details about a conversation that I'm sure never happened.
Oh, never took place?
He talked to me about it for a half hour, and it never happened.
That's very strange.
It's weird.
Yeah. Wow. Talks to invisible people.
It's weird.
Ugh. I love the Scorch. Wow. Look at that. The schedule's getting to you, Carl.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, that schedule's getting to you. You used to be able to trot in here in the morning and full of piss and vinegar, as they say.
Why the hell are you busting my balls? Patrice's been asleep for a half hour.
He was. Patrice just woke up.
Oh, he's sleepy.
You all right, Patrice?
Yeah, he was here.
All right, we're done with Scorch. Let's face it.
Exactly. Patrice is falling asleep.
We're done with Scorch.
What about the weird news, though?
You like weird news?
One more clip, Kyle.
Yeah, one more weird news. That's true.
One more clip.
Let's start off with a segment that we like to call Weird News. Weird News. Scorch bleeding out the fist from fisting. Oh, no, that's not it. You ever heard the phrase, go fly a kite, right? Well, how many times has somebody ever said you go fly a kite? Depot Bay, Oregon, 45-year-old Dennis Brokus just took that right to heart. He was flying kites with his roommate. What kind of a 45-year-old guy flies kites with his roommate?
You the kind that wears pajama bottoms to Walmart.
There you go. His kite got away from
that's
him.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, I know. It would appear that the guy, Dennis, tried to get his kite. But all he caught was air. He chased the kite right off of a cliff, and he fell to the ocean below, and he broke his body into 100 pieces. Ironically, the kite was flying right next to his body, about 100 yards from shore. Dennis's body, as you can see, all broken up. The kite was in perfect shape, so don't worry about it, because the kite was fine. Another one.
That's where the laughing goes.
Yeah, the laughter was supposed to be there in that humorous segment.
The kite was fine.
The kite was fine.
Kite was fine. Oh, all right.
We lost Colin. We lost Patrice.
Yeah, I think I think Scorch might be done.
Yay. No, he can't be done.
Yeah.
I mean, he wanted to debut a new segment for you guys and everything.
Really? What?
Taking it to the streets, which is. T I T T S.
He likes acronyms too.
That's
he likes
right.
rhyming and acronyms.
Yep. Take it to the streets is actually a pretty genius segment.
We could skip to that.
Yeah.
I guess that would be.
That's
let me
fair.
Guess. He talks to people on the street.
No, that would take effort.
But you don't understand. You don't understand the cleverness of Scorch. He almost spelled out tits. Whoa. That's why taking it.
Yeah.
See.
Oh, T I T T S.
Gotcha.
Oh.
Taking it to the streets. Is pictures of street signs.
Colin's looking for his publicist to yank him out of here.
That have funny names.
Oh.
Patricia, all right? What the fuck happened?
It's Scorch.
Was it Scorch?
Scorch happened.
Scorch debilitating.
It really is.
Is that what happened with you?
A chore.
Really?
Scorch just blew me.
Yeah, yeah.
Scorch. Everybody gets jealous that they don't have the chops that Scorch does.
Scorch is like Ambien.
You know what?
Is that what
just
it is?
Just walk around. You didn't know you were up.
So we should play Last Man Standing.
Rockto is like, yeah.
You want to play Last Man Standing with Scorch?
Yes. Let's see who leaves.
See who actually
I'll
is
make
awake
it.
By
I
the
love
end
it.
Of
his
show tonight, Colin?
Yeah.
He has to go sleep. Let Colin go.
I'm not going nowhere.
He's just going to watch me sleep. Fuck.
You see, if Colin like leaves, then we're going to never let it down.
What time's your show?
Eight.
Eight?
Are you talking about the MR or my show?
I'm talking your show.
Because I got the MR first.
What's an MR?
Marriage Ref.
Right. Oh, marriage Ref.
When's that coming on?
FTMR, that's his motto. Patrice is going to get his tattoo, FTMR. Oh,
fuck the marriage Ref.
Yeah.
Marriage Ref's coming on in March, and I'm shooting it today.
Oh, wow. That's a long time.
That is a long time.
You know, a lot of people think TV is actually live when actually sometimes they tape months in advance.